Welcome to Both Down, the Chaos Cup Edition, the number one Blood Bowl podcast
that talks with the door open while pooping.
That's right.
Which Scott loves to do.
Well, I don't want to be left out of the conversation.
No, you never are. It's really disturbing.
Why? It's not like you're going to run in and bother me while I'm pooping.
No. We don't want to walk by either, though.
God. And I am Scott Prime, and with me today is the other ginger badger known as Steve.
Kilowoggy. Title's stuck now.
And off to my right is the Chaos Seesaw himself, Alan.
Yes.
And Alan went with us to the Chaos Cup, so that's why he's back.
Exactly.
That's why he's back.
Because this is our Chaos Cup special edition.
That's right.
I'm just going to move in.
So many people like to make Chaos Cup, though.
I'm moving in too.
Damn it.
We're all going to live here.
It's with our families.
Yep.
Are you paying rent?
No.
We will with the cameras.
I heard that the theme here is you can move over here and you never have to pay rent.
Only for 1 year.
1 year, okay.
Inside jokes.
Anyways, we had a lot of positive feedback from Alan's appearance at Chaos Cup being one of the Both Down guys, so we might have to get him on the podcast a little bit more often.
I would love
if we still have a podcast.
Yeah.
That's right. Well, we're going to find out in this episode.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
So all right.
What are we doing this episode?
What are we doing this episode? First, we're gonna break this down, this whole trip. We're going to talk about our trip from the moment we got into the car until we arrived in Chicago and played our games and arrived back in Oklahoma. We're going to just break those up into segments. The first segment's going to be our trip up to Chicago, Thursday and Friday, all the activities we've done. And then the next segment, I guess, would be a Chaos Cup trip part two. We're going to talk about day one of Chaos Cup. And then we're going to then break down, in another segment, Chaos Cup day two.
And the ride back. Which not much happened on the ride back. We are pretty damn tired.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for ruining it for everyone.
I'm not ruining it for anyone. I'm just letting them know. That segment's going to have the tail end of it's going to be like, yeah, we got in the car and we came home.
Yep,
that was
we
it.
We ate food.
The we end. Did.
Eek, eek.
Anything else before we head off into the segments?
Anything you'd like to say there, Chaos Seesaw?
At this moment, no, not yet. I'm saving it.
Ooh,
intrigue. All right, we are going to take a short break. We will be back with our first segment on Chaos Cup.
Both Down is brought to you by Wizards Asylum, your premier source for comics and games in Norman, Oklahoma. Check them out online at their new home, wizardsnorman.com.
Well, hello there. This is Johnny P., host of the Slurpcast, NAF Media Officer, Chaos Cup Director, and all-around kick-ass dude. You're listening to Both Down with Steve and Scott. Oh, and now it's time for tournament talk. Get ready.
And we're back for part one, Chaos Cup Review. This part, we're going to actually be talking about our trip up there from Oklahoma City, or more specifically, to Chicago.
Chicago!
I guess we could start there.
Yes.
The whole ride up, we were doing that.
Yes. All because of you.
All because of me. Why?
I don't remember the exact reason, but I remember you saying something about Chicago.
We were all talking about Chicago and being excited for it. And I was like, Chicago, and like pumping my fist in the air.
Right. It was like your Peter Griffin moment.
And then I said, it'd just be funny because I'm going to do that the rest of the ride. And then you guys will leave me at the gas station and I'm going to keep doing it. And I'm just going to be standing there at the gas station going, Chicago.
And that became the theme of one guy saying it and the other two guys saying it.
And the whole weekend.
That kind of happens a lot when you have a 13-hour road trip.
True.
Yeah, we talked about many things. Some things we'll talk about, some things we won't.
And we did record stuff that may find its light of day at some point.
And then we recorded stuff that you'll never hear because it was awful.
I don't know. I still want to get that out.
It's funny, but it's pretty awful.
We joked about a segment called Fantasy Racism, and we always wondered what we could put in it. Well, now we know. Because Alan filled us in on a whole bunch of it.
Well, crap, dude. You might as well now just publish it now that you added everybody.
No.
it was all Alan.
We got to tease people. I mean,
that's his way of also pointing the finger at me, so that way if there's any negative feedback, that was not
exactly.
Me.
We just won't ask Alan back again.
What's funny is that segment reminded me of that last Seinfeld episode where they're blaming all those guys for doing bad things their entire life.
I don't remember that episode. I remember it
remember
sucked.
They went
this
to,
is his reference he gets to have, and you don't get to remember it.
Well, I remember the last episode sucked.
Of Seinfeld?
Yeah.
Yeah, it did. It was when they were in court.
Yeah, I remember them being in jail.
They laughed at the fat guy, and then they recorded it.
Yeah.
And then they thought it was funny, and then everybody came around to say all the bad things they'd done.
Oh, yeah, in court. Okay.
Even though we watched those episodes and didn't think they were that bad at the time.
Right.
That segment could be our Seinfeld assholes. Episode, yes.
I could see that.
Yeah. All right, so we drove up to Chicago. We left about what?
We left
5 o'clock?
5 o'clock on Wednesday or so.
Yes.
Somewhere about when we hit the highway.
Mm-hmm.
And
Alan took the reins. He wanted to drive all the way up there, he said. So
oh, yeah.
Me and Steve led him.
It was nice.
I enjoyed driving. That was awesome.
We enjoyed not driving.
It was pretty awesome because Steve, even though it was his car we took, he sat in the back seat the whole way up there.
That was kind of weird.
I found it nice. Odd, but it was cool because I'd rather sit in the front than in the back anyway. So.
Well, I had to fold the seats down, so my arm was basically resting on my bag full of clothes. So I figured it's my bag, and there's not a whole lot of room. I should take the
I mean, you can touch both take of your the bags.
I would like you to note that I didn't take as much stuff to Cast Cup this year as I did last year.
Very
I'd
true.
Like you to tell everybody that.
He did not take as much. He was much less of a woman this time.
I didn't pack as many pairs of underwear thinking I'd poop my pants at some point. Because I thought, I guess I can go buy underwear if I need to.
Exactly.
So
I didn't know that was a problem.
I didn't either.
You always got to be prepared, Alan. You never know when you just try to squeeze one out and you crap yourself.
Well, that's why you just wear the same pair for like 5 days.
That's true. That way,
That's not
it's a road trip, man.
It's a bro road trip.
So nothing really exciting happened.
It is a
bro
trip.
Yep.
It was kind of a bro trip. But nothing exciting happened until we ate.
Yeah, as I say, this is a Chaos Cup review. We have to talk about food.
If you listen to our Zero episode, which was another Chaos Cup trip, you'll know we talk about food a lot.
Yeah, that's the interesting parts.
That's right.
Yeah, we stopped just inside of Missouri. I don't remember where it was.
It was somewhere near Springfield outside of...
No, it wasn't that far.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't
we still had
far.
A couple hours to go when we ate.
All I know is it wasn't Tarawa.
Right.
Right.
That's all I know. It took forever to get to Rolla.
Alan hates Rolla.
Rolla, Missouri, if you're from there, Alan hates your town.
It's the midway point, and we didn't get there on the first day.
No. We stopped at a Hardee's, whereas we normally see him around here, Carl's Jr.
Right.
Same company.
Truck
stop Hardee's.
Which meant that the food is probably going to be subpar.
Luckily, it wasn't.
It was amazing.
It was good.
Memphis barbecue burger. Very, very good.
If you've never had one, it's a hamburger, and they grab a handful of pulled pork, throw it on top of there, and they put, what, onion rings?
No, it was just a cheddar cheese, barbecue sauce, and I think bacon.
You sure didn't have little onion crumbles?
Bacon. No, there's no onion crumbles.
Okay.
It was bacon.
It was so good. Okay, it was bacon then.
Yeah.
Oh, it was so good.
Very good.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh.
They didn't have waffle fries. That's kind of sucked. And their soft drinks sucked.
All I wish I would have done is instead of buying fries and a soft drink, I wish I would have got a giant burger and just drank it with water because that burger was amazing.
Well, we could have just gone next door to the gas station and got their drink.
Yeah, that would have been a smart thing to do.
Yeah, oh well.
But also another cool thing is as Alan's walking towards the bathroom.
Oh,
he's
I
like,
love this. This is awesome.
Oh, hey, look at this. And they've got two pinball machines in there.
Oh, that's not the story I thought you were going to tell. Go ahead. Keep going.
Oh, okay. We'll get back to Scott's story in a second. But yeah. There were two pinball machines, Black Knight 2000 and the Addams Family.
Addams
Family. Two really good machines.
Yes.
Yeah, so we had to play pinball because Steve has a boner for pinball machines.
He always loved pinball.
You got to play the Addams Family one. You just have to.
Addams Family was a lot of fun.
I wish all the lights were working on.
Yeah, unfortunately some of the lights weren't working. The flippers were weak and it was sticky. But it was there.
Yep.
I had my... time with Morticia before you guys got there. Sorry.
It's kind of like a fat chick at 2 a.m.
Is that why
you know, it's not great, but it's there.
Oh, it's pinball. It's nice to see a little arcade.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. So we were also in the same gas station, and you're going to have to tell the story because you told it to me.
Oh, no.
Alan walks by a display didn't he say something like, what the crap's all this Missouri Tigers stuff here? Why is it all in this gas station? And they figures out, oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we're in Missouri.
Oh, yeah, we're in Missouri.
Well, I sort of did the same thing, too, because I saw a giant stuffed tiger. And I was like, why the hell do they have a giant stuffed tiger? Oh, wait a minute. Missouri Tigers. Okay.
Yep. You guys.
Yep. My best friends.
You crazy guys. And then there's not much left of this day.
Well, we looked for Skittles. We couldn't find any.
You mean
no.
Six.
No wonder you didn't find Skittles.
I saw Skittles all over the place.
Yeah, there was Skittles everywhere, dude.
Yeah, that's true. I meant Sixlets.
And I tried to get you guys to eat a Chico stick, and you wouldn't do it.
No.
You were holding it in your crotch.
Anything called a Chico stick. No. That's true. Chico means boy.
That's true.
Boy yeah. stick.
Yes, it's a
penis.
It's a piece of candy made out of little boys.
No, it's a penis.
They grind up kids.
Hey, man, you want to eat my Chico stick?
No.
Come on, man.
Wow.
I'm a scaven.
I can hear the listeners turning us off now. Okay, so after we had the most delicious burger ever, we
jumped back on the highway. And...
Oh, I had a wrestling shirt on, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And this trucker comes up to me and starts like wanting to give me a hard time because I must watch wrestling. And I said, oh, you must watch wrestling, too, if you know my shirt. No, I don't watch it. Screw you, Mr. Trucker. Screw you.
He might be listening to this podcast.
I hope he is.
That would be amazing. We just get one random trucker going. Knows everything
about.
Is.
I know everything about wrestling and Blood Bowl. I can't believe it was that boy.
I knew a celebrity.
Minor celebrity.
Yep.
So then we drove the rest of the way to, what was the town you booked our hotel in?
Wasn't it Springfield?
I thought it was outside of Springfield, though.
No,
it was in Springfield.
It was Springfield.
I called, I booked the hotel. I did Best Western, and I called them up on the phone because, you know, I just wanted to make sure I got the right place and everything. So I call them up. I tell them I want the Best Western in Springfield, Missouri. And she starts going off on price like, well, it's $119 a night. I'm like, no, it's not. $79 a night. That's what I saw online. And she goes, oh, okay. Well, I've got you booked and blah, blah, blah. So I don't think anything about it. You know, I've got Best Western in Missouri. It's right there off the highway.
And then next to what?
Supposed to be next to Shoney's.
The whole freaking reason we go to yes. Springfield instead of Mount Vernon like we did last year is because Steve wants some motherfucking Shoney's like he had last
right,
year
exactly.
for breakfast. So we pull off on this exit. And
we go to the Best Western.
Right next to Shoney's.
Yep.
And she says, no, it's the one down the street.
Six lights.
And the lights weren't separated like if you're from Oklahoma or Texas, like by miles. They were separated by like
mile
5 kilometers
yeah.
or something. Yeah. I don't know.
They were just, it was a city. And we left the city and went to the other city.
Yep.
We passed over another highway. And then we got to pawn shops and liquor stores and some seedy places. And then yep. we finally come to this Best Western.
And it was pretty cool. It was a Route 66 Best Western. It had a
window in the bathroom so you could crawl out
that
after
was awesome.
You kill somebody.
Well, it did have that.
It was clean. It did have the best shower.
I think it had like a 54 Thunderbird out front and something else I couldn't really tell. It's like a 50-something. I thought it was a Chevy, but it wasn't when I got
it. Yeah, it was like a car-themed Best Western thing.
Yeah. It was really nice. They had old gas pumps and memorabilia.
But so, it was way off the beaten path.
It was much more off the beaten path than it should have been, yes.
So, of course, we had to give Steve a lot of shit for that.
Well, yeah. But we just got in the hotel room. Did we do anything that night?
No.
Nothing we want to talk about on the air.
Exactly. Yeah, I remember you yelling bonus storm a lot.
Yeah. No.
He did? I had
no, he did.
I had my earplugs in.
I have it recorded.
Did I?
We got to talking about things. Anyways.
Oh, okay. We'll save that for the secret tapes.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't know what I recorded on that secret tape thing.
Well, you know what? If people sign up for the newsletter, maybe it'll be on there.
Ooh.
How do you do that?
You can go to our webpage, bothdown.com. And
you just caught him off guard because he wasn't thinking of you saying that.
Well, no, I was just thinking the Slipcast does that. I didn't want to actually steal their thunder or copy them, but that'd be a good way to get it out to people rather than just putting up another special episode or something.
Yeah, there's only so many paths on this podcasting stuff.
So, yeah, we ended up just sleeping, waking up the next morning, and getting some Shoney's.
Yep.
The most disappointing Shoney's ever.
Shoney's last year, awesome.
And cheap.
And cheap. This year, expensive, and it sucked buttholes.
Yes. Oh, it was so bad. It was like, what time did we get there? About 7:30 or so?
It was early.
It was 7:30 or 8.
Yeah, and the food was cold.
Yeah.
Everything.
And old. It looked old.
Yeah.
No, the eggs had like a couple different colors. Like you could break the skin on the eggs.
Yep. Pudding skin.
Yeah, pudding skin.
It was gross.
It was so bad. And I think what the problem is, the Shoney's we ate at last time was the only game in town. Everybody went there, so it was constantly busy, and they had fresh food all the time. It had a lot of variety. This one was in a bigger city, so there was other places to eat.
But at the same time, it's also the same time where people would be going to work, so they would have been eating there around that time.
You would think so, but barely not. That's what I'm saying, is since it wasn't so many people going there,
right,
their service and their quality was lackluster.
Yes.
It sucked.
Yes.
It
did suck. Very disappointing.
We had to drive on a crappy meal. Thanks, Steve. Yeah.
That was bad.
Thanks a lot, Steve.
Shoney's was so good last time, though.
So bad this time.
So then, this was Thursday, we're driving up. Anything amazing happen?
No amazing.
Scott played a lot of Pokemon.
Yeah, you did.
I did. I played a lot of Pokemon, and I got my creature to evolve.
Yeah.
That was a goal on this trip. So at least that goal was met.
That's true. You did that.
I can't remember the creature, but it was the dragon guy.
He got three heads at the end.
Right. I named him Dino. I can't remember what his real name is. But
I don't remember.
It goes from a single-headed creature to a two-headed to a three-headed. So it's very important, Pokemon Black.
Yeah.
Ooh, Pokemon Black 2 is about to come out. I'm so
Pokemon
excited.
Pokemon White 2 is coming out, too.
Yeah.
You need both.
No, not me. I'm a 38-year-old man that shouldn't even be playing.
So I'll only choose Black, one. You never go back.
I was just going to make that joke.
Wow. Thanks, guys.
Scott has gone black. We don't judge.
I have gone black. That's true.
Good. So then we're driving, 9 hours that day?
Yes.
Basically?
Yep. Stopped only, the morning, and then when we got there.
Did we stop to get lunch?
No.
Well, did we just have gas station food?
We had gas station
food.
We had Taco Bell. Yep.
We had Taco Bell, Alan.
I didn't need it.
That was about 3 o'clock, though. We didn't have a traditional lunch.
Right.
We did stop and fill up about 11.
Yep.
And that's when I got the Asian peanuts from that really...
Oh, yeah.
It was a gas station that we probably should have never stopped in, but it was actually okay inside, but it was just in a really bad part of Missouri. I don't even know what the town was named, but... It looked like we could, right there in St. Louis. It had bars on the windows, and it looked like we could probably push it over with little effort.
Yes.
Speaking of, if anyone listening to this is from St. Louis, what the hell is up with your highways? They intersect.
Right.
Like, they split, and then it just goes right back together.
It's scary.
It's like a bypass for something, but it's weird. Caught us off guard.
Yeah, explain it to us.
What?
I'm meaning the people.
Explain it to him.
Well, you drive along, and it tells you
I know
80 or whatever. What was it, 55?
Yeah, and it said
no,
on both
I meant
sides,
somebody from split. St. Louis to explain it for
right.
us. I thought you wanted us to explain it to the listeners. But it did split, and then we got about half a mile later, it rejoined.
Yeah. Right.
It was very odd.
Yeah, it was different. So those crazy St. Louisans.
St. Louis hams.
St. Louis hams.
They're just hams.
Yep.
See what you did there?
Don't you? Yes, but don't you call people from St. Louis St. Louisans?
No, I call them assholes.
Wow.
I'm a Cubs fan.
Oh, you hate the Cardinals that much?
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't know.
We saw the Oval.
Sounded funny.
Yeah. The Oval?
We hypothesized that it was not an arch. It was just an oval.
Yep.
You can go down and have a really cool ride.
That'd be neat.
It would be.
You want to go and eat at the top of the oval or at the bottom?
So if you're ever at the crappy gas station in Missouri, you know the one. Get the Asian peanuts. They're awesome. Steve and Alan wouldn't even try them.
They didn't have any cichlids there, though.
Alan's still looking for cichlids.
Yep.
Every time we stop.
Well, he found a few old men who knew what he was talking about.
That's right.
We don't carry that anymore.
You can't even find them at Walmart.
We can't find them at Walmart.
We haven't carried that since 1982, sir.
All my good stuff.
So then, we drove longer, and we finally decided... We knew we were going to eat pizza that night about 8 o'clock.
Lou Malnati's, yep.
So we decided just to have cheap Taco Bell at 2:30, 3 o'clock.
Yeah. Just enough to tide us over.
Right. And that was our last fill-up before we got into Chicago. Because we figured gas would be $4. And we were wrong because it was $4.60 or something ridiculous. It was $4.58, wasn't it?
No.
It was a little over four. It was right at four.
Yeah. Oh, I thought it was higher than that.
No, it wasn't that bad.
Oh, maybe, it was still maybe bad. Maybe I saw like the premium stuff or whatever.
Oh, that, yes. Okay. I'm sure.
All right.
So we get into Chicago, check into the hotel. And
nice hotel.
Very nice. Holiday Inn Express. It's where the Chaos Cup was being held. And we're kind of just relaxing and chilling. And then Alan and I decide to walk the grounds.
Oh, yeah. Just to check things out. Yeah. We had to go look for the pool.
We tried to find the pool, which became an adventure in of itself.
Yep. It was interesting because there was no way to get to it. The only signs you saw were from, well, for us it was difficult.
You walk into the hotel and you see the pools out there. Like, because the hotel's connected to a gym, World's Gym.
World's Gym, yeah.
Yeah,
see, I didn't realize that until after we left a few times to go get food that it was actually connected to the World's Gym. It wasn't the gym of the hotel. It was its own, you know, identity.
Mm-hmm.
So we're walking around, and we find how to get to the gym, because you can access that freely from the hotel, no problem.
Well, it even had signs that said, pull this direction on the second floor, so that's where we were.
So we were just going to look, and we kept looking, and we end up going outside to try to find it, and then we just go back in the main entrance, and it made no sense. We finally had to ask, what'd she tell us?
The lady at World's Gym told us that the way to get there, and the only way to get there, was through the locker rooms.
Yeah. That's weird.
So did you guys enjoy your journey through the men's locker room?
Well, we had to go down some big steps, past a gym that was enclosed, and the only way you can get through it was like a half door.
Right, that's right.
But it was glassed off, so that was weird. And then we went into a whole area that was under construction.
Right.
Then we found the gym, or the locker room for the gym, and we had to go through the showers.
Yes, you had to walk through the showers to get to the pool.
Did you see any guys, like, between the ages of 45 and up, just with their balls out? Because that's the theme at my gym.
I would not have looked.
Okay, this is a tangent story, but...
No, really?
The other day we were working out.
We guy, being?
Me and Brock, who plays Blood Bowl with us in our local home league, who's also traveled with us down to Buckman's Bowl and everything. Right. Anyways, we are working out. We are getting dressed at our locker. We have an old guy comes out. He faces his locker. So he should have his butt to us, right?
I would think so.
Okay. He then wants to dry his hair with his towel that he has around his waist.
Okay.
So logic dictates that if you're trying to be somewhat at least modest, and I'm not the most unmodest guy there is, but logic dictates you take your towel off, you put it up to your head, you dry your hair, and then you cover back up or scrub your balls off or whatever. This guy does a 180, turns around, cock first. He then takes his towel off, dries his hair while his dong's bouncing around. Dong, dong.
It was an invitation.
It was. Invitation. You didn't find that.
Without a doubt. I believe this.
It's like, hey, guys, what do you think about this?
Blop, blop, other people blop, noticed blop. This, too. It just wasn't us.
Did he do the helicopter dick for you?
Helicopter dick.
I didn't look that much, but it was...
That much?
Yeah.
Just enough. He was gay.
He was a very hairy man. You see hair. People have hair on their balls, Steve. Most men of us. Yeah, well. Yeah, Alan. Anyways.
I don't know if that meant that I don't or I do.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Let's not find out.
Anyway, so he dries his hair off while his dong's bouncing around. And then he pulls down the towel, puts it back around his waist, turns around to open his locker and get dressed.
Maybe he didn't want to hit his dong against his locker.
Well, there's logic to that.
I mean, maybe it's happened before. No. Maybe he was... Okay, wait, was the locker open?
Oh, God, that would hurt.
Was it open?
Locker was open.
Okay, that's why. He didn't want to accidentally close his dong in the locker.
That's ridiculous.
Not for Alan.
Well. Some of us are made equal, and then there's Alan. That's the only joke I remember from Arsenio Hall. He came out one night, and he said, all men are created equal, except for Ron Jeremy. And I thought it was hilarious, but I couldn't laugh because I figured I was the only one in the room with my grandparents and my father who had seen porn at that time. And I knew I shouldn't have seen porn and know who Ron Jeremy was, so I just kept it to myself.
Nice.
Late night television.
Confessions of a Junior High Child.
These are my confessions.
All right, so enough about the tangents.
So, yes, we go to the pool.
So you didn't see any dong?
No. I tried to get Alan to take a photo with me in the shower, but he wouldn't do it.
No, I would not. Actually, he didn't tell me that's what he wanted to do. I think he just said, come on, let's go in the shower.
Go in the shower.
Never listen to Steve when he says that.
Should always listen to Steve when I say that.
All right.
So we make our way back, and we knew that Arthur and Alex and...
Dave. Oh, yeah, and
Dave Johan. From Canada, right?
Yeah, but I think it was just Arthur and Alex hanging out at the time, wasn't it?
Well, they were in Arthur's hotel room at that point.
Yeah, we stopped by and met Arthur Inkpen. Mm-hmm. From England.
Awesome guy.
Yep. And then Alex.
Yes.
From Canada was also there.
Awesome, nice guy.
Yep. And they're both on Twitter, but at Inkpone and at Apartment 42.
Yep.
That's great. Okay.
So Al and I said hi to them, made plans to go eat pizza about 8 o'clock, and then got back to the hotel room, found out that Core, the guy from... Denmark, right?
Norway.
No, I think it was Denmark.
No, it's Denmark. It's not Norway. Jonas and Anders are from...
They're Swedish.
Sweden.
Mm-hmm. Sweden.
The other one was from Denmark, I thought.
Oh, now we're confusing nationalities.
That was Duke Jan.
You'll understand why. Yeah, Duke Jan is from Norway. Duke Jan's from Norway. Kor is from Denmark.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But Kor is the Blood Bowl champion. He won the NAF championship.
Okay, but we didn't know that.
No.
Until after dinner.
Yes.
We'll get to that in a little bit.
So, he was at the hotel by himself, so he met up with Arthur, and we find out from NAF forums and from Johnny that he's there. So, we all plan to go out to dinner. Catch the shuttle, we go to Illuminati's, and it's...
It's not Illuminati, it's Lou...
Malnati's, yes.
Yeah. I just don't want people to get confused.
Right. And... So it's the three of us who are American, Alex and Dave from Canada, Arthur from England,
Core
from Denmark, and then Jonas and Anders met up with us from Sweden.
Right. Correct.
So a table of, what did I just say, seven people? Nine people?
Nine.
Around there.
And
I wasn't paying attention to count.
Me neither. We're Americans, we don't do math. And we're the only Americans. Yep. It was pretty cool.
It was really cool. That was awesome.
Pizza was pretty good. Could have been better. We just got individual pizzas. I think that kind of ruined the experience.
I think so, too.
But it was still good.
Alan says that because he used to work at a pizza place, but I still think it was good pizza.
It was okay pizza, in my opinion. I mean, it was good, but definitely the personal pans definitely made too much of the crust.
Yeah. And that's when we got our first taste of minor internet celebrity.
Absolutely.
That's right.
Because I kept seeing the guy eyeing me across the way.
Alan thought he was going to get picked up.
I thought. No.
Is that what you were after?
He had a chance.
Yep.
Alan was hoping.
I went to wink for him.
He's like, it can't be gay if we're in Chicago.
No. You can have as much gay sex as long as you don't like it. We discussed that.
Why would you keep doing it if you don't like it?
Well, you got to make sure you don't like it.
Exactly. Let me try it one more time.
I mean, you've never had pickles.
Right.
And you eat a bite of pickles and you go, I don't really like this, but I'm not sure...
I don't like pickles. I don't keep eating pickles.
Look, hey, I don't like strawberries.
Have you ever had two bites of pickles?
Right, exactly. You may not know.
You might do it twice.
I don't like strawberries, but I keep trying them to see if I like
them. Or maybe you tried a dill pickle, and now you want to try a sweet pickle.
Okay, that's true.
And see if it tastes any different. And then you go, no, I don't like those.
Maybe I'm not that gay, but I might be this gay.
But I'll try one more bread and butter pickle before I end this... Pickle experiment.
So anyways, getting off the pickles.
Hey, at least I know that I'm less gay than you guys because I've tried more.
Wow.
We are leaving that in.
Oh, gosh.
That's what Alan's boyfriend said, too.
Boom.
Right in your butt.
So, yeah, as we're eating, I want to go to the story about Core because I found this entertaining because I was sitting next to Core.
Oh, okay.
Right.
The guy who won the NAF championship.
And we think that's how we say his name. That's how we say it, anyway.
It's actually spelled K-A-R-E, and there's some squiggly thing or something over a letter, probably.
Stupid Americans.
It's close enough for Americans.
Right.
Right.
Cole. Super nice guy.
Oh, yeah, super awesome guy.
super giant.
A little bit more quiet than we are, or yeah. at least I am.
Subdued, yes.
But somebody mentioned about like either how cool it would be to win Chaos Cup or maybe place or something. And then so other people started talking about success in tournaments. I think – I thought, Steve, I don't know if you did say it or not. I think you said something like, well, I won – you know, I won Bugman's Bowl. And somebody said, like, I won second, or I've done this before. Well, Corsett next to me, and he – doesn't speak up at all, but just lightly he said, I've won a tournament. And that's all he says. I've won a tournament. That's it. And we still didn't know who this guy really was. I thought I recognized him, but I just didn't know.
He's a ringer.
And so, but he didn't brag about it. He didn't, you know, he won the biggest prize there kind of is. I mean, yeah. if you had to win one
the
tournament,
biggest tournament,
that's the one I'd want to win because that's considered the Blood Bowl.
It was like 180 some people.
Yeah, 180 coaches. He went 6-0 with Dark Elves.
Wow.
You know, if you go back into the fluff of things, that is the Blood Bowl. That's the same Blood Bowl I played with in second edition. So that's the one I'd want to win.
Yeah, it's the one it's named after. So.
Exactly. So he just quietly goes, I've won a tournament. And that's all he said. And I just thought that was, I think that showed a lot actually towards his character.
Yeah.
Because I mean, he was a great player and we saw that again throughout the tournament, but it wasn't a big – I mean, he was there for business
right,
and stuff. He wasn't cocky or anything like that at all. So.
But back to the guy who was eyeing Alan.
Okay.
Well, I thought he was eyeing me. Turned out he wasn't.
Well, he kind of was. So there was a gentleman looking across the room over at Alan, and he noticed a bunch of
– He actually noticed my shirt, I think.
Gentlemen with a similar appearance, as some people like to say. Nerds.
Yeah.
Blood Bowl players.
He noticed that I had a Oklahoma shirt on.
That's right.
And that's what made him
tipped him off.
Yeah.
So anyways, there's a guy that gets up, and him and his wife are getting ready to leave, and all of a sudden he goes, excuse me, are you from the...
And he taps me on the shoulder. He goes, are you from the number one Blood Bowl podcast? And then he made up something, and I can't remember what it
was. Right. And so...
and I'm like, yes, I am.
So we met Kent, K-Raff,
yep.
from If You Play Fumble. I played him. I found out I've played him on... Fumble, and he beat me, or tied. I think we tied. Really nice guy, nice wife, and everything. And yes, really
they drove even farther than we did.
Yeah,
they drove from Austin.
That part sucked because
which
we were
is another 8 hours.
I know.
Or six. It's at least eight. Yeah,
it's at least six. It might be closer to eight.
Six to eight, something like that. So long drive.
So yeah, we were hoping to be the furthest driving people.
Yeah, he said he's not doing that again.
Yeah, I bet they fly next time.
I do not blame them.
Probably took them at least two, 3 days.
Oh, had to.
Yeah. Unless they did 12-hour days, which would be ridiculous.
Yeah. But that was pretty cool, getting recognized. He said he liked the podcast.
So sure he does. Thank you, Kent, for giving us a big head
by
making us feel like minor celebrities.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Very cool.
But Alan's University of Oklahoma shirt tipped him off. See, he put two and two together.
Yep. I was Oklahoma proud.
Then, we went back to the hotel, and Alan and some other people gave the... But the
okay, hold on.
Bus driver pizza.
Should we not mention the story from the Sweden guys?
When they walked in, I think you should. Whatever.
Well, I did. I'll fess up this. Jonas,
that's
who is player of games. I think there's underscore in between everything on Twitter. He'd mentioned that he was going to be in town and wanted to meet up for pizza, and I said, "Cool, you know, we'll be there." I totally spaced. I mean, we had everybody else there. I thought I had him. And then he, while we're at dinner, he tweets me. He's like, so are you guys at the hotel yet? Oh, yeah.
See,
yeah.
I wasn't even talking about that part of the story where you lost him.
I would have missed out on
that. Oh, that's all I knew. I mean,
okay.
So I felt bad about that, but they didn't have any hard feelings.
So we're sitting there eating.
It's the best part.
And Jonas and Anders come in.
Oh, yes, this part. Okay.
And somebody from that end of the table... kind of toyed around with the nickname of calling them the Nihilists from the Big Lebowski.
The Big Lebowski, the Nihilists.
I think that was Dave. I don't know if he's the originator of that,
right.
But I heard him use that terminology to describe these guys. Very nice guys, but they are from a different country, and I'm not used to their body language or anything.
Mm-hmm.
So they sit down and immediately, so I'm here. You going to rape me now? Was this thing. And he was coming at me.
Right.
And I didn't know this guy. And while I joke about many things, sexual and poop related and other things, I don't ever remember telling somebody that I was going to rape them. But he assures me that it's him, and I did it months ago on Twitter. And we go back and forth. And like I said, I don't know this guy. I don't know his body language. I don't know if he's about to eat his pizza nicely and then punch me in the face with the pan. Or if he's just giving me crap to tease me now that we're in person.
Right.
So I'm trying to fill this guy out, and he keeps saying, no, you told me on Twitter you're going to rape me. You're going to do it now? I'm right here. And he kept giving it to me.
They do not sound like that.
Well, my work. I can't do accents or anything. But he's all about, you know,
he's all about the rape.
About giving it back to us.
Yep.
Or me. And so we finally dig up, and we find out. The whole time I'm saying, I don't think I said that. We find out who said it, Alan.
I believe that was Steve.
Well, actually, you'd have to look at the thread. The thread was basically other people talking about how we should rape his team. Then it was one of those things of like, I'll pass it along. And I added you to it. And you said, okay.
Right.
So I like added you to the thread. And you just replied as a joke. And then it's just something you'd forget about.
Exactly. You
know, he favorites it.
and so now
he meets us and he's like, oh, I'm going to kill you guys.
It's one of these things from like comic books where like, okay, I'll remember you and 10 years later I'll get my revenge. And
yes.
Here I am. It's like, oh boy.
So whatever you put on Twitter, be careful.
Yes, because it can come back to haunt you. It can be favorited and somebody can get in your face while you're eating pizza. But no, they were giving us crap back. It was pretty fun. And
he was
awesome.
A lot of fun.
Yeah, those two were great. I mean,
yeah.
I love those guys.
They all were.
And stuff.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Well, they were more vocals. I talked to them a lot. I had breakfast with them when you guys ate breakfast with me and stuff like
I
that.
See.
I probably talked to them more than I got to talk to Core and stuff.
Oh, okay.
So, but yeah, great fun time.
Then I guess we just went back to the hotel and hung out in Arthur's room for a while.
Yeah.
Yep.
And
they had us take pictures to tease Magnus.
Yeah, that was cool. And we got to talking about Bonus Storm and rape. There was a lot of rape jokes going back and forth.
Oh, all gosh. Because of that. Yes, all because of that conversation.
All because of the initial conversation.
Yeah. So if you saw any of our tweets and were wondering why people were tweeting about rape.
Yeah, there was
it's
a thing Scott of
and
like,
Jonas's fault.
It's not my fault. We're going to blame this totally on Player of Games. This is
absolutely.
Jonas's fault. And that's why there was a hashtag rape for a little while on every Blood Bowl thing, because everybody yes. thought it'd be funny. And then we just hung out. The guys played Bonus Storms. Congratulations to Alex.
yes.
You know, Apartment 42 on Twitter. He won the game of Bonus Storm.
Yay!
And so, Alex, we're real proud of you, dude. It takes a lot of guts to really triumph in that game, and Jonas got second. I mean, Jonas played hard. He did a great job.
I do believe everybody played hard.
Yes, we had to.
Of course everybody had to play hard, but those two guys played harder than others.
Well, I think Scott might have to put up Bonus Storm rules on the website.
that might be a good blog one day.
It might.
It's awesome.
Boner Storm.
One day you're going to get a video of that.
Who I feel bad about is James Roofer. He wasn't there he won Bonus Storm last year at Chaos Cup 2011. So he wasn't there to, you know, try
defend
to
his title.
Defend his title. But, you know, congrats to Alex. And I think Alex is coming back to Chaos Cup next year. So maybe a Roofer will be there and those guys can square off. And
Bonus Storm we'll champions rematch or matchup.
We might have a repeat champion at Bonus Storm 2013. Wow. So that was Thursday.
That was Thursday.
Just Thursday.
Wow.
Just Thursday.
So let's get to Friday.
Friday. We had a screw-up with the shuttle from the hotel, and we did not get to the Cubs game on time.
Yep, missed the first
train. Long story short, the shuttle people were supposed to get us to the train at a certain time, all of us, because there was 23 of us going to the Cubs game, which is a lot of people.
Yeah, tons of people.
And that's good. I mean,
I think the major reason why was because they couldn't have somebody with the big bus, right?
Right. They didn't have someone who could drive the big
bus.
They had
to
take two trips in the smaller one.
Mm-hmm. Short bus. Yes. We had to take the short bus. So a group of us went over with the short bus, and the plan was to wait till everybody gets there before we go
head
into
on.
Town.
Right.
And Johnny and those guys who were organizing the event, they got over on the other short bus too late, and so we were an hour delayed.
Not a huge deal. We sat down and chatted and had some drinks.
Yeah, it gave us a chance to talk to more
people. All honestly, it didn't bug me at all because we did the Cubs game last year.
Thank God. Being a huge Cubs fan, if this was my first year, I would have been livid. But of course, like I said, if this was my first year, I would have had backup plans. Mm-hmm. I would have made sure that, you know, we had ways of getting there on my own.
Well, and if
but the, it's not a big deal.
If the Cubs were in the playoff race, that would be a different thing, too. But, you know, the Cubs.
It was just
Cubs.
A blow-off day. It was still fun.
So next to the train station, we walked over to a little bar and grill. Some people mm-hmm. had nachos or a burger or something, and then everybody, had, I think, had a beer pretty much or a drink.
Yeah. And I got to say, those people took care of us very well. I mean, they were awesome.
They did. I can't remember who they were.
What was that place called? It was like a stripper. It had a U in it instead of
it was like a stripper.
No, it was like a weird name. I know that. I just can't remember what it was.
It sounded like a stripper joint, but it had a U in it instead of like a R or instead of R. Like an E instead. Like Curvy's or something?
I don't know.
I can't remember.
Nobody cares.
I would know it if I saw it. But
okay.
Was it Curvy's?
No.
No.
Nope.
Anyways.
I didn't take a picture there, so I don't have any documentation.
Nah.
So.
But you can check the pictures on the Chaos Cup forum or the Chaos Cup website. I bet there's pictures there that say what it is. And then we jumped on the train, headed out there.
First train
watched ride. The Cubs game. Oh, it was your first train ride?
Yeah. It was awesome.
It was fun.
Me and Alan took pictures of like random girls that didn't know we were taking pictures of them.
It was fun.
Should have seen the girl that sat across from us.
Yeah, that's what we were taking pictures of. We were trying to. We just missed out on that one.
Huh?
I have pictures of her.
The one that was bending over?
Well, I wasn't like totally perving to see her boobs like you were.
Oh, well.
We were just proning our...
Had full on view.
Yeah. We were just, you know, honing in on our stalker skills a little.
She had to pay for her ticket, and she was on top, and the ticket taker was on bottom. So she was bending over to pay, and, you know, you wear a shirt like that, you don't leave anything to the imagination.
Nah. But, yeah, there was that hot blonde waiting for the train, too.
Before.
Yeah, I got a picture of her.
That's right, you did.
Check out the cast cut pictures. I sent all those pictures to Johnny, and I don't know if he didn't look through them or didn't care, but he put the ones up of all the girls from the train station.
No way.
Yes, he did. They're in there.
That's
Boom,
awesome.
Boom, both down.
I am not affiliated with this.
You only actually really looked at her naughty parts.
Yeah, I didn't take photographic evidence.
I was admiring her beauty.
Exactly.
Mm.
Sightseeing in Chicago.
That's
a sight
to see.
It's all
in public.
Yeah.
So we get to Chicago.
Took
the
subway.
Train ride.
And Alan just Alan.
We had to walk a little ways to get on the subway.
Well, we get down to the subway.
Yeah, gosh.
And we're trying to buy tickets.
Yes. Yeah, go ahead.
And the girl in front of us has a $5 that the machine won't take.
Yeah.
Because it has tape.
And we were going to use $15 of our own to put in the machine. So
we all gave the money to Alan.
Yep, and I'm going to put it in the machine and then use it. We were all going to use one card and then go into the, you know, use it, just one card for all three of us.
So Alan thinks he's going to, like, I guess, flirt or bang this chick in Chicago. So he's like,
she was
hey, man, would you like another $5?
I'm going to help someone.
She could not get her $5 bill in there, and I wanted to hurry up and get through. And it just so happened that she needed help, and I had a $5 on me because you guys
You had three $5 on you.
Yes.
One for each of us.
So I traded her a $5.
So now you have two good $5s and one $5 that we know doesn't work.
Right.
Right. So he has to use a 20 because that's all we have left.
So I put one of my 20s
in. Which is way more money than we need because we only need $14 total.
So it's not even like he traded out a $5 with her. He really just gave
Lost
her
$5. Yeah.
Yes.
Actually, no, I didn't give her $5. She traded out a $5, and I gave the $5 that was left over to somebody else.
Yeah, but still.
I gave away $5. I get that, but, you know.
For a chick.
It wasn't just
for
a chick.
That he doesn't even know.
Just a chick.
Dude, if that was me... Chicago, Scott, you would have been like, I wish this... Chicago.
What, Chicago?
Yes. All right, there you go.
Jeez.
If that was Chicago, Scott, there was no way you'd be, sir, do you mind if we go ahead and go ahead?
Our Here you go, sir. Gone. Here's $5.
You stink and you smell like mayonnaise.
Yeah,
I
would have.
Would you?
Thanks, mister.
Because she was turning around to go and ask her friends who had already gone through the terminal if she could get some help. And I just thought
maybe
that would help.
If those were real friends, they would have stayed there and waited on her. Those weren't real friends.
It's not for us to save everybody.
Doing something nice.
Well,
doing something nice.
I did a lot of nice things that weekend.
All right.
I did. Anyways, let's move on. We finally make it through the subway.
Yep. Which was fun, by the way.
Yeah.
First subway.
The first ride out was
different.
Was fine.
It wasn't as crowded.
Ride back was crowded as fuck.
Yeah, it was because 5 o'clock traffic.
I know, but
we'll get to the Cubs game.
Express.
We have fun.
Yeah, the Cubs game was great.
We missed the first three innings.
Four. We came in on the fourth.
We came in on
the fourth.
Bottom of the fourth, yeah.
I got to eat my bison dog with grilled onions and cheese. Oh, so delicious.
It was cool. I mean,
I didn't have any great food. I didn't buy anything great. I got another souvenir cup and a pennant. That was cool, but nothing major.
Yeah, I just got a ballpark dog is all I got.
No, you always get the bison dog. It's really good.
Bison dog is good.
But anyways.
What
else did we see? We saw some hot girls there.
Yeah. Well, it's Chicago. We're always going to see hot girls.
Right. It was not that packed this year compared to last year.
No.
Not at all.
We were able to sit all together. All of the global players got to sit in one section.
Yeah, I think he had us in groups of, what, eight?
Something like that.
Spread out. Or in the same general area. But
and it didn't matter.
It didn't matter. Yeah, our whole area was bare. But Cubs won.
Yeah.
And that was good to see. And it was fun. I mean, yeah, I got definitely enough of the game.
Yeah.
And then we
Cubs are going to win today. I was trying to remember that song.
Oh, gosh.
That's the first time I heard it, and I actually liked it. I was like, cool, they have a song at the end of their game whenever they win. That's neat.
All right. So we watch the game. Yeah. We come back.
Good game.
The Subway was really crowded on the way back. Yes. Oh, my gosh.
Packed in there like sardines.
Yes. I could not get a good handle, so I almost fell down.
Oh, yeah, many times.
Yes.
Many times. That's when we found out that the drivers in the afternoon, their job was to only try to make us fall.
We think they got points based on how many people they could knock down.
Yeah. Oh, probably so.
Yeah.
I got to touch a girl's breast with my elbow.
Well, that's good.
She was so packed in, and there was like nowhere for me to move, and she just kept doing it. And I was like, God, I wish I had fingertips on my elbow. I'd like to really enjoy this moment, but I can't. I just know it's soft.
That reminds me of an HBO miniseries.
Fingertips on my elbow?
No.
That sounds like a Lifetime show.
The boob touching in the subway, where Rosie Perez played a woman who was on a subway with a man, and they would gently caress each other with the pole.
I'm going to go to sleep.
Anyways.
What? You don't remember? Okay.
Okay.
No, do I not remember HBO miniseries starring Rosie Perez?
No, it wasn't starring her. It was one of the stories of, so like it was like various things. Like,
oh, okay.
All right, guys, we got a lot of Blood Bowl to talk about.
Oh, sorry. My tangents can't go.
No, Scott's can. For,
yeah, my can.
Minutes, double tangents.
But not yours.
Double tangents.
I am one of the ginger badgers. You're just the extra man balls.
He's the only ginger badger.
Then we went to Ron Jeremy's penis. We can go that route.
You can talk about Chrissy, Janet, or Jack all you want, but when his friend comes in, Larry, you don't focus on him.
Why did you go Three's Company?
Exactly, because
you
could have
gone
do
some buddies. Or
right.
I don't know.
I don't know any other duo. Will and Grace.
I'll be Chrissy. That's fine.
Well, I know the guys from Bosom Buddies.
Yeah, I am
Chrissy. I just didn't know the chubby girl on Bosom Buddies that was always there.
I don't have a clue.
All right.
Another tangent because of Alan. God damn it.
Anyways,
Alan.
I didn't break my phone this year, so we just went straight back.
That's very true.
So
good job.
Made it through the subway. We
got
it
lost
the train.
Because of Johnny.
Well, we didn't get
for
lost.
For a second.
For one block.
Yeah. Then we had to
We had to turn back.
We saw the cool homeless guy playing the cup full of change.
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
I don't know how you afford the batteries for that radio.
He had a boombox.
Big boombox. That thing had to take at least six double
Ds.
He kept dropping his change every time he was shaking.
Yeah.
I feel like making love.
And it was like it was looping that, too.
Yeah, it was.
It wasn't going to any other part of the song.
Exactly.
Because we walked past him, and then we had to turn around and walk past him again, and it was like, feel like making love.
I kind of thought it'd be neat to actually sit there and sing along with him for a second, just to see what would happen.
Paying him like $100.
Those guys start eating people's faces.
Could have.
Okay.
Oh, and I even said that we should have followed some random person with all the people that we had.
Yes, that would have been awesome.
Been great. Just follow some random person and see what they do.
And whenever they turn around, we just all turn around at the same time.
Yes.
Oh, gosh. Think anybody's going to listen to this?
No,
not
hope
this
not.
Part.
So we get back to the hotel. We get some food. And that night, we have our showdown.
Yes, we do. We do some
Zlipcast Wrestling Federation.
That's right. Johnny's N64 No Mercy League.
No Mercy, that's right.
Great game.
Such a great game. You can customize characters. It's wrestling.
That's cool.
Yeah.
It's good, an updated version.
It's good good controls for a wrestling game. And we had the Team Dubinsky versus Team Zlurpee, I guess it was.
And I was on Dubinsky. We should have won.
Yeah, there was some great matches with some people. Too many draws for my taste, but some of those matches would have lasted 30 minutes.
And we had Scott and I had a cage match.
We did, and there was
Prime versus Woggy.
And there was no way that
I
could
won.
Beat Steve.
No, I should have won.
Because he's like an idiot savant when it comes to games.
Yeah.
He's just going to be that much better than you. And I knew the only way I could beat him is really if I did my finisher and then climb the cage.
Well, that's the only way you can ever climb the cage unless someone just stops.
Right. I was hoping you would mess up
on
the cage part. So that was my hope, is that I could climb out.
Yeah.
And we just kept climbing the cage, and the other guy would shake the cage until it knocked the other guy down.
Yep.
And then it was repeat, repeat, repeat. 10 minutes later,
yeah, draw. It was a draw. Still a lot of fun, though. Mm-hmm. And that was great because you had a whole room full of, what, 15 people?
Every bit, yeah.
20 people. And all screaming, strong grapple taunt! Strong grapple taunt!
How do I do my finisher? Strong grapple taunt!
Strong grapple taunt! And so we're screaming and yelling, and everyone's having a good time. So we finally called a night. I think we were one of the first ones to leave.
Oh, yeah.
Because we were tired. We were pretty
very tired after the long drive and everything. So as we're walking down the hallway, we get the elevator. Elevator opens, and security walks out.
Yeah, we walk right past security. We're like, good timing,
very good timing. So we get back, and they got busted, but they told the security that they were just finishing up. So
they should have just yelled at them, strong grapple taunt!
Strong grapple taunt!
That really was the hashtag of the rest of the weekend.
Yes, it was.
For that part, yes.
That was used a lot.
Oh, yeah.
So.
And then we slipped. And then I guess we'll go ahead and take a break and then come back and talk about our first day of Chaos Cup.
Yeah, all the fun is over, and now it's time business.
Work. Now it's business.
All right.
We'll still fun, this. Just different type of fun. We'll be back.
Hey, guys, this is Extreme, and I just want to let you know I'm a homo, and you're listening to Bolt Down with Steve and Scott.
And welcome back. We're going to talk about the first day of Chaos Cup. There was four games during this time. I know I got up actually early because I couldn't sleep very well, and I got up at like 6:45. You guys slept in.
Yeah, it was nice.
Mm-hmm. And
we bought earplugs this year. Have you heard of us complain last year? We brought earplugs.
And they worked awesome.
Yeah, slept so much better.
I didn't even use it after the first day.
No, Alan slept underneath the air conditioner the whole time.
No, I honestly didn't. First day, because I'm used to the snoring, and you guys weren't that
bad. We forgot to tell everybody, me and Alan played a practice game, and Alan realized like all these traits on his characters and stuff on Friday night. Remember we played a half game before?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Before we went to bed. It was good practice.
I didn't pay attention.
It was a good practice.
Steve was watching porn.
I hated your freaking...
What was it, Bailey Ray? Bailey...
Bailey J.
Bailey J. He was watching Bailey J porn.
No.
Say, so what is Bailey J?
We talked about this.
This was the training we talked about.
Oh, okay, I remember now.
Is she female or trainee?
I don't know the difference. She's not a trainee. She's a...
Female. Okay.
Yeah, anyways, she's a female.
We'll move on.
Tangent.
Just don't do not Google that at work, fellas.
Or do.
Nice. You want to be fired, yeah.
If you want to get some weird looks from your coworkers,
you could do it from somewhere.
Anyways, what did we do that day? We got up. I got up first.
We had breakfast.
Whatever breakfast they had at the moment. Apparently, yes. It closed at exactly like the 45-minute after mark.
Yeah.
The breakfast was fresher and a lot better on Saturday than it was Friday.
Yeah. Mm. More people.
Totally different people. Yeah, more turnover for more people and stuff. And it was really good. I mean, for a free breakfast.
Yeah.
And I got to eat with Anders and Jonas and Extreme's wife, Jennifer. We all ate together. I mean, there was a whole table, but that's the end of it.
That was the day of the Gamer versus Asian Warfare, wasn't it?
Yes, there was some type of Asian conference or something there.
Asian conference.
No, there was something.
We need to have a conference about Asians.
There was two big rooms of breakfast, and one side was all Asian.
I know. I went down for breakfast, and there's one side of the room that's completely filled with gamers, and the other side of the room is completely filled with Asians. I think they were Japanese. Close enough. Either Japanese or Chinese.
So you probably just offended somebody.
Well, no. They have differences. You can tell.
I know, but you said close enough.
Well, it was one or the other.
You know, they probably say the same thing about us.
Well, yeah, I'm sure.
He was either American or South African. I don't know. Close enough.
I've been confused with South African.
Okay.
Afrikaners.
Okay.
Anyways, so I grabbed my breakfast, and there's no room in the gamer side, so I had to go sit in the Asian side.
You're tolerant of all people, so you went over to the Asian side.
Yeah, I don't mind.
You're breaking
crossing
barriers.
The border.
I tried. And then people joined me, Arthur and Zoot Suit Jeff and...
You're a pioneer,
Matt,
dude.
Everybody. Yep.
You join people together.
Yes.
Not only in Blood Bowl, but in breakfast.
I try. Yeah. So we get up to the room. Nice room. lousy sound system. And let's see, we met Rich. But
that is not Johnny's fault.
Oh, no, it's not Johnny's fault. Just
and
stating.
I thought it was nice that they had speaker systems. Yeah. It just was tweaking out too much and stuff. But room was huge, big.
Yeah. Plenty of room.
It was cold, which is good once you start gaming, but I was freezing when I first got up there.
Yeah.
So I had to go back and put my long sleeve shirt on for a while.
And I got to say, it was actually really nice to be able to hang out with the people before all that, because that way, whenever we got to that room that day, it was just cooler because you knew.
We knew a third of the people.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. And even more if we've talked to them before or not.
It definitely made it much easier.
Right. If you haven't heard, 80 people was there.
Yeah.
That was the final number.
Record for North America.
Right.
Which is awesome.
Our rivals for the podcast showdown, they showed up.
Yeah.
30 minutes before the tournament started, and so didn't even have their rosters checked out until then and everything else. They were
being
sneaky.
Part.
Yeah.
I didn't know that either.
You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah. Well, I assume
they're just not as good.
Right? If you just show up, you
don't
have
your rosters. They had to break down our
team. I don't think they pre-registered, what I understand. But there was there was at least 10 to 15 people that didn't pre-register, which is still fine, though. I mean, it's good.
Yeah. See, before we started, we just kind of milled about and talked to people. We were wearing our brand new Both Down t-shirts.
Oh, yeah.
Which got a lot of comments.
Yep.
That we will probably be trying to sell if you'd like a t-shirt eventually.
Actually, yeah. If I might have that up by the time this goes up live. I'm working on a store right now. Just order through the website and I send out a receipt, and then my brother makes them up and sends them out.
And before the round started, I got to meet Rich from Utah, who's a postman who listens to a lot of podcasts. And he was like really happy to meet us and stuff. And he's
very nice guy.
The show, and so it was really cool to
said
see
a lot
of the
nice
fans.
Things about the podcast. So that was good.
Yeah, I don't know if they're true, but that made us feel good.
Yeah, I'm okay with people lying to our face.
That's right.
Right.
Might as well. I guess before that we met Matt, because we met Matt previously.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Matt Texas. Matt from Texas, a big fan of the show, tweets us a lot.
Him and K-Raf both were in the Austin League, are in the Austin League, and he gave us some t-shirts. They're really nice from his gaming group down there. Mm-hmm. So if you...
Sooner Red are close enough.
Yeah, not really. They were actually.
Yeah, they're pretty close.
So if you meet us in person and give us stuff, we'll talk about you on the podcast. We are bribable, very much so.
That's right.
Yep. Are we ready to go match by match?
I think so.
Anything else, Alan?
Oh, it was sponsored by Nurgle King, so we had a lot of grown men wearing crowns.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know where they got those. They weren't actually Burger King
Dollar
crowns,
store.
But they were just, they were just generic crowns. So
crowns.
All of us
they were cool.
Guys, for extra tickets, because Johnny had drawings between rounds.
Yeah.
My head is too big, because I guess it kept falling off and distracting me. I was playing, it felt like I couldn't move, because every time I moved, the crown would fall, and then I'm trying to not have it fall, and then I'm just going back. Yeah, I was very uncomfortable in the crown.
Well, like I say, it looked very...
Alan refused to wear it.
No, I would not.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
He's like, I am not attractive as a king.
It's not going to mess up my hair.
No. If you look around the room and you see all of the gamer guys...
Look,
with
some
crowns
of us,
on, I'm sorry. That's
some
just...
of us grew up with Mike Tyson's Punch-Out.
Yeah.
And like to be King Hippo.
Yes.
Okay? Yes. I was like,
there was a ton of King Hippos there.
There could be only one.
Oh, there was a lot.
There was a lot of King Hippos.
If we all would have taken off our shirts, we could have had a King Hippo look-alike contest.
That would have been fun.
Wow. Alan's like...
King Hippo contest.
Alan's like, I'd like a bunch of bears to get naked around me. Because that would be fun.
Oh, that's
it was
good
cold
point.
In that room. I needed to get warm.
So before we go off into another Alan tangent, Scott, why don't you tell us about your matches?
All right.
We're just going to kind of go through them kind of quick this time.
Yeah, let's go through all four matches. Before I start this, though, I mean, wouldn't you guys say that Steve's played Magic with me at least when we got into Magic for that 1 year?
Yeah.
And so we've been to tournaments with 30 people or
even
bigger. Alan, you've been to the Oklahoma Bowl.
Mm-hmm. Well, we also have run plenty of HeroClix tournaments.
And HeroClix tournaments, and I was going to say other gaming events. Or we've been to conventions where there's gaming events going on, and we've walked through them, down at Wizard World, HeroClix Championships and stuff like that. Blood Bowl guys, you should be very proud, because most of you guys know how to take showers and use deodorants, and you don't stink.
Right.
And that's pretty amazing. Because
it's very nice.
You break that gamer, what is it? misnomer that everybody's stinky.
Stereotype.
Stereotype that everybody's stinky. I'm sure there was a few buttholes there at Chaos Cup that most people hate. Luckily, I didn't run into them. And I would say I've
at least... I don't know there's any that people hate.
I'm saying I didn't meet all 80 people.
Oh, yeah.
I'm saying I probably met at least 50 people out of the 80. I'm saying I did not run into anybody that I go, oh, I hate that guy. I never want to talk to him again. And you know my personality.
Yeah.
I'm a quick judge on people, right or wrong, and I throw them in a box and go like, I never want to talk to this guy again. Mm-hmm. I do want to talk to this guy again. So I'd like to just say hats off to the Blood Bowl community. You guys did really well in representing the human race.
And it was extremely well run. We didn't have any problems.
And- oh, yeah. I was going to get to that later. But, yeah, Johnny and those guys handled it like there was 40 people there instead of 80 people. So, all right. So match number one, I got to face off against Matt.
And this is your Oklahoma Badgers?
This is my Oklahoma team? Ginger Badger team that I talked about in the podcast. And I got to face Matt McDonough first round, the guy that we talked about earlier who always tweets us and brought us the t-shirts and stuff.
That was first round?
That was the very first round I got to face him.
Oh, okay.
Really well, cool, painted orc team. It was almost exactly like mine, except he didn't have the extra player. He had the apothecary instead of the extra player, but down to the skills, everything was the same. So it was black. It was his Black Orc Bok Bashers, which is off of like an ale in his fluff. It was a very fluff-related team. I really appreciated playing that. Just because I'm a geek that way, because these matches happen in my head. So I like to make it feel like it's in the Blood Bowl world. And we had a really good game. It came down to first half, I got the ball. I tried to throw a little pass. He intercepted it.
Wow.
On the play right before half. And so it went 0-0. So I thought I was going to lose this game because I thought he was going to just drive down the same way I did and score on the last play.
Right.
Luckily, I did hurt. Casualty one of his guys early, and that gave me a man advantage, and I managed to get the ball away from him from a missed pass and score, and then it gave him two plays to score, and he came very close. It came down to just a couple of, you know, he had to like get a six on a dodge or something like that. Yeah. Something ridiculous, but that I made him earn it, but he failed. Anyways, I won 1-0. I was start off Cast Cup really happy. Second game, I played Alex Meyer. I think his name's like Dean 17 or Dino 17 or something like that online or his NAF number.
Yeah.
He had a Chaos team. Everybody was like so shocked that he had the Minotaur on there because he had break tackle on the Minotaur or claw on the Minotaur.
Good.
And it was cool. Well painted team and stuff. Nice guy. I got the ball kickoff again. He stopped me. He scored in the first half, so then I thought, okay, well, I'm going to lose 2-0 because of the way things go. And I managed to stop him in the second half. I got a man advantage on him again because I think he only had like 11 guys. And then I scored near the very end and tied it 1-1. So I'm still happy, you know.
Mm-hmm.
One win, one tie is not bad.
No, it's good.
And then we went to the break, and then we came back from the break, and I played a guy who online name's Bo. I think that's his real first name, too. But he had an orc team that was the exact mirror copy of mine.
Same skills and everything?
Same skills, same number of players, same everything.
Jeez.
It was like I just made a copy of my roster, and I said, why don't you go rename these guys? And his colors were even like black and flames instead of orange like my team was.
Yeah.
It was flames. So it's kind of hard to tell, you know, characters apart. I mean, he did use the plastic models instead of the ones I did. So there was some difference. But I got my ass kicked in this game. Everything I rolled was, you know, you roll dice. And,
did you play bad or just bad dice? Because I know third round is where I made some mistakes because I was tired.
I did make talking to Bo later. He claimed that, you know, like, you know, I thought you did good. It's just the dice that were bad. I don't know. I felt like I made a few mistakes.
Yeah.
But I had bad dice rolls. You know, I used my rerolls early. And then he really kicked my butt because he injured a lot of my players. It was at one point where I had, like, three guys in the KO box, one guy in the casualties.
Jeez.
And you don't want to get down when you're slow orcs.
No.
And so he just overwhelmed me. He won 2-0. And so be it. So I took my first loss. And then round four in the final game, of the day, which I was tired. I don't know about you guys, but by mid-round three, I was like, oh, my God, I don't know if I have another game in me. But I was tired of just playing Blood Bowl in round four. I just got fatigued. I don't know if it was because there wasn't like a soda machine.
It was the cage match.
For the night before.
It wore us out.
For the night before. Well, I mean, there wasn't easy access to like a go get a soda or something on that floor. And I was frankly too lazy to walk down stairs.
We didn't have a whole lot of time either. We didn't.
Because if your game
goes to the end, then.
You're right. Yeah. And all my matches did go to the end. Fourth round, I played Drew Bucciacone from the 3-die block over the podcast there.
Silky tones of Drew Bucciacone.
Yeah, he had his Lab Rats team, which is a Skaven team. I thought it was well designed, and I don't mean this in a bad way. It was kind of confusing because, and I don't know. In my head, I get so stuck on when I paint my guys. You know, I put the color stripe around like the blitzers, and then I put like the letter of whatever skill I have. Yeah. And my skills were very simple: block, guard.
Mm-hmm.
Very simple leader. He had a Skaven team, and I think almost everybody except for one guy had a skill. And he used the rubber bands, and they were well marked. It just, I wouldn't say I was as smart as the average bear, so at times that kind of confused me, and I had to ask a lot of questions. It's not any fault to him. Most people use those rubber band things, and really, yeah. I'm probably going to get some too because it's just easier than painting the word block on the bottom of the
definitely
thing. So but everybody had a skill. They were great skills. I thought it was a well-designed team, and I couldn't stop his speed. We went back and forth one-to-one at with like four plays left in the game. I took probably maybe with two plays left a calculated risk by just running up a blitzer and trying to get as far upfield as I could.
Yeah.
Hopefully he would miss the tackle and I could just dodge away and score for I was going for the win instead of just sitting around trying to get a tie.
Of course, as you should.
And I went for it, and I fell. And so the next play he picked it up. His gutter runners were MVPs, man.
Yeah.
And I beat him up casualty-wise, but they're MVPs. He threw a little pass, which turned into a long pass after the other Skaven ran it in, and I got beat 2-1. So, but it was a good game. I had a lot of fun playing him. His mind's better than mine because at the end of the first half after I scored, he was looking at I on the board and he was looking to score in one turn by doing a bunch of pushes.
Mm-hmm.
And if he would have got the dice rolls, he would have done it. So, I mean, hats off to Drew. He's a good player and stuff. So it was a lot of fun. And that wraps up my day one. Steve, you want to go through yours?
Not particularly, but I guess I have to. My Dzworski Kodiaks, my human team, is what I took. My first match was against Mike Bielik. He had a Dark Elf team called the Fallen Angels. And he actually had a board from the West Coast Quake. He was at the first one, so he won it.
Ooh, I like those boards.
Yeah, and it was signed by everyone who was there. So it was kind of neat. Since he won it all, he got that.
That's cool.
Well, he tells me, as we're starting, that he's kind of a slow player. I'm like, oh, that's no big deal. He goes, no, really, I'm kind of slow, so if there's any problem, just let me know and I'll speed up. Sure, no problem. I didn't notice any problem. It's not like he played slow to an extent that it felt slow, and I was probably playing slow too, because, you know, it's the first game, you don't realize it. But I start wiping the floor with him. I did 3 casualties on him.
Wow.
Which I did not expect at all. So I was feeling pretty good. He ended up scoring. And then I had to go into 3 tackle zones to pick up a ball. And I got it and dodge out.
Nice.
And I think I had to go for it twice to get a touchdown. Something like that. Something crazy. So I ended up getting a touchdown. So we're tied 1-1.
Nice.
Second half comes around. And I'm heading for a touchdown. And we're told that time's about to run out. I'm like, the hell? Because we didn't, you know, the guy next to me, his opponent didn't even show up until after we had started.
Mm-hmm.
So we didn't think anything about it because Johnny had come by and seen us about at the 1 hour mark and we were on pace, I guess. Mm-hmm. We just slowed down somewhere. But I used my wrestle, got the ball away from the ball carrier that he had. I got the ball. I go to throw to my person. All they have to do is have a pass and a good catch, and I can go in for a touchdown, and I fumble it. It ends on turn 2.
Of the second half. Nice.
So it was like, wow, what the hell happened?
A lot of what ifs in that game with six plays left each.
It was very much, and like I said, he was down by three guys, so I felt like I had it in hand, and I knew, you know, that just all I had to do was catch the ball and I would have won. But that's how the games work.
That's Blood Bowl, man.
Exactly.
I had one win, two losses, and one tie, but I easily could have, in theory, you know, three wins and
exactly. I'm going into it thinking, okay, I'm not doing too bad. You know, it's a tie. It's not a loss. And it could have been a win. So I wasn't too upset about it. And I thought, hey, maybe I go up against weaker people next round. So that'll help me out. Then, round two, go up against Arthur and his Southland Fish Canners, which are...
That was the Underworld team.
Underworld team, that's right.
Really cool looking team, too.
Very cool team. And I have not played Underworld near enough to know how to beat that team. Because... And, you know, it's no problem. He's got squigs?
Squigs for his blitzers.
And, like, a bigger squig thing for a troll. And
yeah, I mean...
It looked awesome. Yeah, and I didn't have any problem telling them apart. But when I haven't played the team too many times, I don't really know what they are. So I have a little problem.
Right.
Which I told Steve he should know them since he played them in our league.
I played against them.
But then I remember he didn't do so well against my team.
No, I did not. I took notes, and my notes suck. I still don't know. I thought out beforehand. I'm like, I'm going to take notes on every game, so when I go back and review it, I can just look at my notes and remember exactly what happened. My mind does not work that way.
No. It takes too much time to write all that stuff down between each
turn. You're pretty busy anyway. When you're just playing, and you have 2 hours to get it all in.
Yeah.
Your mind starts blanking out.
It does, and... You know,
I tried to keep stats, and
there's no way. I did the first game, and that was it.
Yeah.
So, on this one, again, it ended up being a tie, 1-1. Again, one of those that a die roll here or there, I could have won. Die roll here or there, he could have won. So, two ties. It's not horrible.
No, it's good.
And again,
ties better than loss.
Maybe I'm going to go up against someone weaker next round. Right. So then I can get a win.
Right.
It's my thought, anyways. So, third round, I go up against Andy, Major Tusk, and his Mad City Maulers, the dwarf team.
Right, I've seen them before.
Yay. Major Tusk, dwarf team. He's the only person who's gone to every single Chaos Cup.
They smash your face in?
He knows how to play.
He knows how to paint, too. He's good at painting.
So...
Dude, is your notes that bad that you can't read them?
Yes.
Just remember the game.
Yeah.
I can't remember the game.
What? Then just skip it.
No, my mind does not work that way.
Wow.
I cannot remember the games.
Oh,
crap.
I can remember dice rolls.
I can remember some.
I just remember getting beat.
I remember a few of my games, not all of them. So if you just don't remember, don't say all of it. Just say, yep, this game was sucky.
Yeah, he beat me 2-1.
Oh, that wasn't as bad as it could have been. Could have been 2-0.
Wow. You could have got your butt kicked like me.
Think positive.
He's still looking at his notes, trying to decipher something. If your handwriting's that bad,
maybe you should.
No, it's bad. It's just I made all kinds of notes, and I'm like, I don't. I'd have to actually sit down and read them to figure out.
So you
what
got
the
beat
hell.
2-1.
I got beat 2-1.
All right, so game four.
I play Chicago Sarge or
Chicago Sarge.
We call him Chicago Sarge because we have a Sarge here in Oklahoma.
Yeah, we have an Oklahoma City Sarge on our team.
Strong up,
and I lost there again too. So that's
another
it.
Underworld team.
Yes.
What?
Madcaps, Shroomers.
Yep.
So you don't like Underworld teams?
I do not get Underworld teams at all. And he had Fez Glitch. Fez Glitch is a little bitch.
I don't even know what that
ball
is.
Ball and Chain.
He's the ball and chain. Okay. Ball and Chain Skaven with Hideous Appearance or whatever. Foul Appearance.
Foul Appearance, yeah.
Oh, wow.
I did throw a 2-die block against him uphill and took him down.
Nice.
So that was nice. But he also taken down like 3 of my guys since then.
And didn't Sarge ask you, oh, do y'all still play with random skills? And you said yes. And he goes, why?
And I said, because for fun. He goes, oh, okay. Well, yeah.
I'd like to add a note to that since Chaos Cup, Sarge has actually contacted me privately through the Slurpee forums, where you could have a section on the Ginger Badgers there. I'm both down. He's contacted me about how to run leagues with random skills. So...
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Maybe we got to him.
It's cool.
But, our game was a lot of fun. He's just a super cool guy. everybody I played was good. You know, I didn't have any problems with anyone. Even the guy, like I said, we were slow, but I was just as guilty. I didn't realize it was that late. So I didn't have any huge problems, but two ties and two losses, I was not feeling it still. Yeah. And I know my third game, you know, thinking back, I know that there was at least two times where I made a mental mistake. And I was like, I'm just tired mentally.
Yep.
And then the fourth game, I'm just like, I don't even care anymore. I just want this done.
Well, it leaves you, Alan.
Yeah, oh, the chaos. But Sarge did mention, I'll just say this, he said my team was confusing. And I didn't think about that.
You have a human team.
Yeah.
The latest human team.
Right, the most recent human team.
From Games Workshop.
And I'm using the positionals as they are. And
they're not confusing.
Well, no offense. I can understand it because I don't see them as confusing because
you've played them before.
Yeah, they're my team. Mm-hmm. I can tell them apart, no problem. But, you know, thinking back to other people playing them, yeah, they can be kind of confusing.
I can see that.
Okay, you can say that, but when I played Bo's orc team,
yeah,
I was confused a little bit because they were the plastic miniatures, because I was used to my orcs. Yeah. But really, that's my fault. He had them clearly marked.
Oh, I know. I'm just saying I didn't think about it. I'm saying for other people in the future, if you have a team and you think it's clearly identifiable, there might be other people out there who don't see that way. So the rings probably are a better way. Because if I had the rings, then I could just slap them on there.
Okay.
And for skills and stuff. So that helps identify.
Right. I'll buy that.
That's all I was going to say.
For a dollar.
You buy that for a dollar? All right, Alan, how'd you do?
Let's see. I'm not going to go as much detail as you guys did.
That's fine.
I'm gonna...
Like I went into detail. I don't know what I did.
I can't read my handwriting.
It's not even that. I would have to read all of it.
Okay.
It's in order. If I read all my notes, I'd figure out what I did.
This would be fairly easy to go through.
Game one.
Just do it already.
Fine. I went with my halflings, and first team I went against some Nurgle Rotters. And that game was...
Was this Mike Muller's team?
Yes, it is.
Also known as Valdric.
Valdric. That's right.
Cool.
Called the Social Diseases. I want to make sure I put out the names of the teams.
Nice.
Let's see. Let's go quickly with that one. That one was actually a loss, but it wasn't too bad. It was lost 2-3. He scored 3 touchdowns. I was able to score 2.
A lot of scoring.
Yeah, it was. We weren't hurting each other as much as we were taking the ball down the field. So
right.
Not that we were trying to do that, but just this way it was. And he was a little distracted because he was helping out with the tournament still a little bit.
Yeah.
But yeah, he was a great guy to play
against. He's on the Chaos Cup committee.
Right. Let's see. The second game, that's the one of my favorite ones to play just because of how ridiculous that one was. That was the one against the Goblins, the Wonkaville Wonder Boys, with a chance from 3 dive block.
Ah, yes.
Ooh.
Yes.
Another heads-up challenge.
Heads-up challenge with 2 stunty teams also.
I didn't get a heads-up challenge. Huh? I didn't play either one of them.
You gotta play better.
You didn't play Nate either. I don't know. The other third member.
Oh, yeah.
We all had 3 people, Steve.
Did they have 4?
No, they had 3. They might have had 4 people with them, but there was 3 on their
right,
team.
Right, yeah.
Right.
Well, I played against him straight up with 2 stunty teams and lucked out with a tie on that one.
Now, he is the returning stunty champion from last year.
See, I didn't remember that part or didn't know it. Yeah,
well, yeah, he won Stunty Cup last year at 2011.
With the Goblins, right?
Well, same Goblins.
Same Goblin team.
I think that's why he brought him back.
Yeah.
I also heard that Alan.
I think I might have surprised him, so that's what happened.
I would think you surprised him.
Yes.
You have to tell the story.
I will. Okay, so I don't know who got the flip or whatever, but somehow I got the ball first. And he set his players up on the field.
I'm going to assume that you won the flip if you got the ball first.
Yeah. That's true. I probably did. I got the ball first. With the flip thing, that doesn't matter because there was a guy at the very end that decided he won the toss and he wanted me to take the ball first. So, which is weird, but just saying, that's why I couldn't remember.
Okay.
Anyway, got the ball first. He set his players up on the field with his goblins and his, what are they called?
Secret weapons.
Yep, he put some secret weapons on the field and... I decide that since I'm playing, you know, my halflings, that I want to throw a player. So
the whole car ride up here, all Alan's saying is, no matter what happens, I just want to do a 1-point turn touchdown.
Even on the last podcast, yep. Alan's like, I don't care, you know, what my record is, as long as I
just want to do that and surprise somebody and shock them.
Have some fun, yeah.
Have fun.
Well, first turn, I do a little bit of blocking, not much, you know, going on there, but I remember getting the ball. Walking it up to a tree man, you know, handing off to another player, and threw my halfling, got 3 good dice rolls on the scatter, and then landed it, made a one turn touchdown right there, straight off.
So Chance lost all his secret weapons.
Not all of them. I think he lost two of them, but he had to use a bribe or something like that. Or
nice.
Maybe, you know, couldn't remember if he had one or not, honestly.
You ruined the plans.
Yes, I ruined his plans.
That's good.
Well, then he took the rest of the half to come back, and I believe at that point scored before the first half was over. So So at the end of the first half, it was 1-1.
That's the problem, scoring fast. You got to give them 8 chances to get it in.
Exactly. Well, then the second half starts, and he gets the ball first. I can't remember exactly how the whole half went, but I do know that it took him, I believe, the entire half to score his second score.
Yeah.
So now it is down. He has finished his half on his 8th turn with now 2-1. I have 1 turn left to go. I decide I'm going to throw a halfling again. It's the only chance I have anyway, but that's fun.
Yeah, of course.
I think he even had, oh yes, I do remember. He actually had his players set out to where they would space far enough apart that I had to dodge through them anyway, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, threw the ball, threw the halfling just right, was able to dodge away from him and still make it in, I believe. Jeez. So one turn touchdown at the end. So
you bookended it with a touchdown.
Yep. Well, nice. My first turn and the very last turn of the game. So
you got a tie. That's awesome.
Exactly. 2-2.
Nice.
Not so bad. See, the third game was against Alex and his Amazon team, the Martian Menace, which was not my favorite, only because I couldn't do anything against them. It just felt like they were stronger than regular Amazons, it felt like. I don't know. It was just one of those games where I was like, this is tough.
Too tough.
Yes.
But, especially in a tournament format.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, look, I got 6 Blodgers and 2 with Wrestle.
I don't think I can't remember if it was that bad, but I know it was close, but anyway, he's a lot of fun to play against as well. Not that I'm saying Chance wasn't either. He was awesome to play with. I forgot to say that about him. No, it was all fun.
And this is Alex, the guy you kept calling Canadian
the bonus
George
sword
Michaels.
Champion.
Me, it was both of us.
I do not believe I ever mentioned Canadian George Michael until this moment, sir.
No, that is not true.
Wow.
That was Scott.
Of course I'm going to get the blame for it. And you know what? Everybody in the world's going to believe it.
That's
because
true.
That's how
nice
it works.
Yep.
Yeah, you're the nice one.
Well, no problem.
Hey, it's not an insult. Canadian George Michael is a good thing to be called. Unless you're in a bathroom.
Dead silence.
That's all it takes.
All right, so I ended up losing that game 1-2, which wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. So far, I'm still pretty happy with the 3 games, even though I've lost the 2 games. I didn't lose by much, I felt like. So.
Did he cause many casualties?
I can't remember.
Did he ever go wham?
No, he didn't. That was a bad George Michael joke.
Yes.
All right. The last game of the day was against other goblins.
Did he speak loudly, or was it kind of more like a careless whisper?
In the wind. No, wait, not in
Isn't
the
that
wind.
A song?
Yes.
Wham song?
Of a good friend.
Careless whisper.
Of a good friend.
Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
Okay. Whatever.
I'm stuck.
On a serious note, Alex had a really cool converted alien team.
Absolutely.
He had these little gray aliens, and they were his Amazons.
They were distracting. That's what it was.
Amazons, and they were really cool. He had like little flying saucers for like rerolls and stuff.
Yep.
The picking up cows, too, which was amazing.
Yes, it was awesome.
So hats off to him and his talents there, man.
Yeah, I think he won Best Painted last year, so he decided to go goofy theme this year.
Was he at last year's Chaos Cup?
I think so.
I think this was his first Chaos Cup. I'm
pretty
sure.
Anyways.
I think he won Best Painted at Spike.
Oh, I don't know.
I could be wrong on that. But his painted team, all matter of fact, all these painted teams you see pictures of online, they look so much better in person.
Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. Yeah. Definitely much better in person.
Especially mine.
Matter of fact, I think the guy that I played against on the 4th game was the one that ended up winning the painting contest, I believe. It was the Goblins, the Masochists.
Was that GW Junkie?
Yep, GW Junkie. Yep. Mike Bell was
Mike
name.
Bell. Yeah,
yep.
He won. Yeah, painted.
That was great. That was a good painted team. Well painted, whatever you want to call it. That was my favorite game of the day. I feel really bad for his team. It was a matchup between two stunty teams as well, halfling against his goblins. I cannot remember. Honestly, this game went by so quickly, and it was pretty amazing. I know that on the first turn, I casualty'd his troll, or one of his trolls, and then the very next turn, he ended up turning around and casualty'd my Deep Root Strong Branch, my star player, right off. So I had a feeling it was going to be tough, but after that, it just seemed like the roles just went my way. I ended up winning that game 4-0.
Jeez.
Wow.
With halflings.
That is so impressive.
Yes, I remember looking at the score at the end of the game. I was like, no way. I didn't get four, did I? Really? Really? And he was like, yep. Oh, man.
And that put you at, like, what, 9 for the day for touchdowns?
Touchdowns at that point, yes. I was 9-4 and 7 against at that point. So
jeez.
Overall, doing great.
So we had one win, two losses, and one tie. He was the best of the team both down.
Yep.
Or at least tied for the best. At least tied for the best. Had the same record.
Oh, yeah.
Same record, but I think what was your touchdown at that point?
Oh, gosh. You had more touchdowns by this point than yes. I did for the rest of the whole tournament.
Chaos Seesaw. I'm telling you.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So that ended 4 long games.
You see, you guys are talking about how tired you guys were at the end of the fourth game. I honestly think that by the fourth game, I was getting very used to my team and how to play it, and I was actually enjoying it more.
Is that advantage. I was just tired, especially, like I said, near the end of the third game, first half of the fourth game, you know. So
yeah,
I was into it. I was ready to play more at that point. But
what else did we do that day? We ate at probably the best.
For lunch, we had White Castle.
We had White Castle. It was actually good.
Really good.
And I'm not joking. It was like the best one I've ever ate at before in my life.
Jalapeno cheese.
Before then, we were like, why would people really eat at White Castle? After then, we're like, oh, okay, now we get it.
Yeah, this one's pretty good. Yeah. It's really good.
And maybe it's because we got there right before lunch hour started.
I don't know. I think the people that was working there actually cared about making decent food, as good as food
they
as
did
White
a
Castle
good job.
Can be.
Oh, absolutely.
So, yeah, hats off to them. At Cass Cup, Johnny had drawings throughout the rounds, and we lucked out. And between one round, I got the team manager game.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
I won the drawing for that. And then I also won the Nurgle Legacy team after the second round, I think it was, he gave away the Nurgle Legacy team that looked amazing.
Mm-hmm. And Legacy team, for people who don't know, is since it was Nurgle-based, then they decided that there would be a team of Nurgle that people would volunteer to paint one miniature and then provide towards the team. And everybody who did so would get an entry into a raffle to win the team.
Right. Which is a great idea.
Right. So, we each did up our own little miniature. Mm-hmm. And Scott's daughter, Wakelin, actually did a miniature.
Yeah, and technically she's the one who won.
And she's the one who won. So she got her first Nurgle team.
Yeah, when we found out about this, I asked Sarge, I was like, can my daughter do one? She loves painting and stuff. And
she really did most of it.
She did all the base coating that I went.
Yeah, you did the basing and right.
That's why the Nurgle Warrior, the Rotter has blue hair because she wanted to have blue hair on it. So
it works.
It worked and stuff. And then they called out her name, and I picked up the team. And when we got home, she really loved looking at it and stuff. They're creepy, awesome. Dad. They're creepy. And she, of course, she gravitated. I like the cheerleader the best. I was like, oh gosh.
Yeah.
But it was really cool, and that's where my luck ended, was the second round.
Yeah.
But
Scott did very well in the giveaways.
And what do we do?
Coming back from lunch at White Castle.
Yes.
We got an extra
We picked
passenger.
Up somebody.
Yes. Really nice guy.
Do you remember him?
Matt Blauten.
That's his
name. I think his name.
Awesome.
B-L-A-U-T-E-N, I think.
Okay.
Big Canadian.
Super nice guy.
Dude, yes.
Awesome super guy. Fun. He's like, oh, the both down guys. You can give me a ride? Awesome.
Yep.
So he got into the both down mobile, and he was just super happy to be there.
You guys want a burger? I'll give you a burger from a sack.
He was going to give us a burger after we just had like 6 burgers apiece or something ridiculous. It's like, no, we're full, dude.
But he was a great guy.
Super nice guy. Yeah,
yeah, he was so cool because I thought it was hilarious. He's true Canadian. Mm-hmm. Like, he's got the accent and the mannerisms and, which is awesome because he's just a cool guy.
And it makes it kind of fun to listen to him talk.
And it's funny because Alex, also Canadian, had mentioned the fact that, I tell people I'm Canadian and they don't believe me. They're like, you don't have a Canadian accent. What's a Canadian accent? I go, well, you got a boot and a and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then as we're walking back from lunch, all three of us and Matt are going, and Matt's like, oh, hey, guys, I really do appreciate you guys giving me a ride, eh? So it was a lot of fun, meeting you guys and all this stuff, eh? And as we're walking past Alex, I'm like, that's a Canadian accent. He just looks at me. He's like, oh, okay, shut up. But, yeah, super nice guy, and he enjoyed the podcast, and I guess they were going to walk back, and since he had the food, his cousin asked if we could give him a ride.
Yeah, they were buying food for a whole bunch of people. So. Mm-hmm. That's cool, though. No problem.
And then that night...
Well, during the day, we didn't want to participate in the scavenger hunt, just because we're lazy. Scavenger hunt.
Scavenger. They said Gurr.
Whatever.
Scavenger hunt. Whatever.
It's scavenger.
We didn't really want to participate, but Extreme's wife made us. She just signed us up and said, you have to. And since we have the podcast, we're like, okay, maybe we'll do so. So we were team four, and...
Team four, yo.
And it was awesome because...
We added Arthur Inkpen to our team for it.
Arthur had been hanging out with us. He was a really cool guy. You know, we've known him from Twitter, and he's a fellow brony. So, you know, we get to talk about that and comic books and all this stuff. So, one of the things on the scavenger hunt, of course, the whole concept is you have to find items. And when you find them, get a picture of your team number and someone's face in the photo.
Yeah, the whole paper, whatever. Yeah.
One of the things on the list was a brony wallet. And it says Arthur Inkpen has one.
Yes.
So, not only did we think, hey, you know, we know Arthur, we need another person for our team, let's grab him. We can also go, hey, Arthur is one of the things that is on the list.
So we can...
we can get his wallet from him, and then nobody else can get a photo of it.
Absolutely. So me and Arthur exchanged wallets, so when people would go up to him and need that picture, he could go pull out a brown wallet and go, I don't know what Johnny's talking about.
I left it at home.
And so I got to carry the cool brony wallet for a day.
And as much as Scott can give me hell about bronies, wallet's cool.
The wallet's pretty dang cool. I got to admit, if it wasn't associated with My Little Pony, I'd really like it.
So for the scavenger hunt, I'll just give you a quick rundown. Fortune Cookie, ZWF Screenshot, Brony Wallet, a Mikey, all 5 Chaos Cup D6s from this year and last year, someone from Canada, a pick of G-Dub, Main Guy, Other Guy, Crane Kick, someone playing a guitar, Nurgle Chaos Cup coin and patch, a Sonic sign, which is a restaurant around here, Chaos license plate, Games Workshop employee, Fox and the Hound waitress, ants, a sweet ass, team member in a ball pit, Dundee sign, which is that's the street that we're on, was Dundee, exposed toes, beer head, long tongue, butterfly press, Chaos Cup trophy raised above your head, red shoes, monkey, and guitar rocking out.
Boom!
We got a picture of every single one of those things.
And more.
And a lot more.
Well, yeah, we got to that stage of being so tired, we just took goofy pictures.
Which was fun.
Yep.
But that we, night was fun. We'll finish that story up. After the round's completed, we ended up going to Fox and the Hound, which is a pub and game restaurant.
Yeah, where everybody else
is. It looked really cool.
Yeah. And, you know, they have pool tables and darts and stuff. Well, we get over there, and, you know, we haven't eaten since, what? I can't remember what time.
We ate after the first round break, I think. Right. Didn't we?
Mm-hmm. We may have.
We did.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Because it was two breaks. I forgot about that.
It was two breaks. So the first round break is what we...
So about 11 o'clock?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We hadn't eaten since then. Now it was...
Eight something.
Eight-ish?
Yeah.
So we go to sit down. Starving. And the place was packed.
They weren't prepared for us.
They were not prepared for us at all. No fault of Johnny's. Just, you know.
Well, he warned them that he's going to fill this place, and they didn't believe it. Because I'd say, wouldn't you say 75% or more?
Probably.
Of the people were there?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And it would have been nice being able to sit down and talk with people and hang out. But it was just way too loud. And no waitress was coming anywhere even close to us.
Well, I would have dealt with the loudness. It's just that we just didn't get served at all.
Yeah, that was the main problem.
Well, we got told, like, at least twice, if not three times, I'll be right with you guys.
Oh, and you were?
No.
I was.
Oh,
no.
We didn't.
Me and Arthur actually told the waitress, like, we're ready.
Okay.
And I think you guys walked off or went to the bathroom, washed hands or something. But, yes, me and Arthur dealt with them a few times, and we were like, and after a while, we finally said, let's get out of here.
Yeah. So we ended up eating at Portillo's.
Portillo's.
That was good.
Same place we ate last year.
Right.
Same chain, just different place.
Right. So, yeah, it was in the same parking lot.
And it ended up being the three of us, Arthur and Matt from Austin.
Matt from Texas. Mm-hmm. And we had a good time.
We had a really good time.
I mean, I probably actually saved me a few bucks because the food would have cost a little bit more at the other place. It'd been better food. Most likely.
I don't know. It was pretty good food.
Arthur got hit on.
Well, Arthur did not get hit on. Arthur
ordered before. Let's give the guy some credit.
No, I'm just saying.
Good job,
Arthur
CB.
Ordered before I did. And as he walked away, one of the gals taking the orders was like, oh, he had a British accent. And the other gal's like, oh, those are so sexy. And they're talking like that. And I'm,
see?
And I go, I can fake one. Does that get me anything? And she just kind of does, you can pick up your order down there. No, and that's why she's dead now.
So, yeah, we... So, yeah, we had lots of food there. And then after that, Matt went back to the Fox and the Hound to drink some more.
And we were going to, but we decided to finish up the scavenger hunt. We knew that we were missing photos, so we had to go to Walmart and do it.
And really, for the day, out of 12 games, we only won two. So we were thinking, we might as well win the scavenger hunt.
Yes.
So
we're going to win something, damn it.
We went and got all the rest of the pictures we could until about, was it like midnight?
It was late.
It was later than it should have been. And we were tired.
But it was a lot of fun. We saw a inflatable black cat that was on top of the shelves
and then
for
Steve
Halloween.
Made me mount it.
And it looked like it was presenting itself. So we pulled it down and Scott started humping it. So when you look at the pictures from Chaos Cup, you'll see Scott humping a cat.
Yeah, that was me. Steve made me do it.
Oh, what pissed Steve off was we get back to the hotel room, and I'm the one taking all the photos. So I go through them on my phone. I have to do an email for each individual photo. And as I do, I go to the next one. I do it. I go to the next one and do it. And next one. It's like 35 photos because I'm doing all the ones we have to. Mm-hmm. And I'm throwing in the extra photos that are funny.
My beef vagina.
The beef vagina from Scott. The
enter sign.
The enter sign. I think I sent that one.
I saw it.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's on the Chaos Cup.
Yeah.
There was a sonic sign that says enter. It was like an arrow, so it had Scott bending over, looking innocent. So I sent all these.
Oh, yeah.
And I look on my phone, and just to make sure they went, and they're all sitting in my outbox, just not moving. And I'm like, fuck. Okay, I got to make sure this is done, because I know I'm going to want to sleep in. I don't want to wake up and have to fight with this. So then I had to get on the computer. Luckily, I brought my computer. And move all the photos to the computer. And then send them out through the computer's, you know, the Wi-Fi connection and all this. That took me a lot longer than it should have. So I'm so glad we won. Well, and then we get to talking. And I guess at the end, Johnny's like, well, each team's missing one because we tied with another team. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, but we're not missing one. We sent in one for everything. He goes, no, we didn't get a picture of G-Dub. Yeah, you did. Well, I made sure we got a picture. And the picture of G-Dub was brilliant. Alan did this. We're at Sonic. He pulls out a $1 bill and puts the sign and the $1 bill up, and it's George Washington. So G-Dub.
Right.
And I sent the email saying, you know, G-Dub in the title. You know, that's what Martha calls him. And I guess what happened is the photo was cutting off the four on the team.
Yeah, the rules, I guess, state that you had to have a face.
And the team name and number.
Yeah.
So that screwed us there. So they got it, they just couldn't accept it.
Right.
So that's why we tied.
Well, the coolest part also to me is that the people that we tied were the same people that we tried to block off at Sonic so they couldn't get any more. We saw them taking pictures.
Yeah, they obviously didn't stand the Fox and the Hound either, so...
That was kind of funny. Maybe they saw us leaving. They were like, "Oh no, they're gonna get more."
And they were the only team to catch Arthur before Arthur became part of our team.
Yes.
So
it sucked. Which we didn't know about.
I guess we might as well
day.
Finish this story because
might as well.
Even though this happened Sunday, since Steve started this, we might as well finish this before we take a quick break and come back on Sunday's events. On Sunday, we found out we tied, and me and I think it was Bo. The guy I played in the third round who kicked my butt, I think he was the team captain. Johnny goes, you guys got to come up. I'm going to tell you.
Oh, yeah. And these are the same guys who won last year.
They were repeat champions. So he's like, there's something hidden or something missing from Chaos Cup. Good luck. And so I run outside to the hall, and you guys, I guess, were coming back from snacks or something.
Yeah, well, we were just goofing off in between rounds.
Okay. Well, I'm glad I found you then because...
And we were right in like a little alcove right by the
there was like a seating area.
There's a seating area by the conference room. So Scott runs out. He's like, guys, we got to find something. And we're like, what?
And I was like, I'm not sure. Something missing for Chaos Cup. And then, so we just, we run up and down the halls a few times.
No.
No.
You did. We start looking, and we happen to be right in the area.
Right spot at the right time.
So we're looking. I saw a door that was open that shouldn't be, so I look in there. There's
nothing. Well, I think I ran up down the halls before I ran into you guys.
Oh, maybe. But yeah, Alan just, he like walks 5 feet, turns around, and goes,
yep.
Here's a bag. What's this?
Right.
It was something that was like in a spot that something shouldn't have been.
So yeah.
And it wasn't, I mean, we found it, or Alan found it, what, 4 or 5 seconds probably before the other team would have, because they were hot on
their
heels.
They were right next to us.
So I grabbed it, and I just take it to Johnny. Well, I guess the instructions fall out that says, grab the Chaos Cup, hold it over your head, and say, we're the scavenger hunt champions, or something like that.
Yeah.
And so the other team actually said the phrase before us, but they didn't have possession of it. So it was almost like we were going to get into like a strip ball war. So I got to hold the Chaos Cup over my head, say the phrase, and we won the scavenger hunt.
Yep.
That's on Sunday.
And we won a band of orcs for that.
We did. It was awesome.
Very cool. All right. We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back with Sunday's events.
Hey assholes, this is Tom Rummery. You're listening to Bolt Down with Steven Scott. Fuck off.
Okay, we're back with the second day's events of the Chaos Cup.
Chaos Day 2.
Sunday.
Chicago.
So I might as well start off, because mine's halfway interesting. My first game was against Joe Gruber, and this is Dr. Kitties, I believe. Played him last year, and I beat him last year, and he got his revenge this year. So he's playing Dumpster Mummies, they're undead, and I lost 2-0, I think.
Can you not read your notes again?
No, I can't read my notes.
Did you play any games that you remember at Chaos Cup?
No, I don't remember stuff.
Were you drunk?
I was not drunk, I just don't remember stuff.
Wow.
It's just how it is. That's why I write notes that I can't read.
I think it's because it's Chicago.
Chicago.
Well, plus, then I remember the last game. Okay, Dr. Kitties, I'll say this. I could not do anything against him. I know that everything that he rolled worked. Everything I rolled did not. It was one of those games that I can't even get mad about because he beat me so bad that I just couldn't do anything. There was nothing at all throughout that whole game that I could do.
I understand.
But my favorite game was the last game. And there's a reason. I had the Dyskwerski Kodiaks, which were based on the Chicago Bears. And my opponent had a human team, also, named the Acme Pac-Men. And they're named after the Packers. So the Green Bay Packers.
Oh, yeah, that guy. He was decked out, too. Yeah.
He had on a Green Bay Packers jersey.
Mm-hmm.
He had a vest that had Green Bay Packers stuff on it.
And an old-school leather helmet.
Old-school leather helmet. So he's dressed the part. So we had Bears versus Packers, and I beat him 3-0.
That's awesome.
And this was the vice versa of the last game. Everything I did worked, and everything that he tried failed. Like, I was trying to screw up, and I was just succeeding. Like, I was doing just stupid stuff, and I was just succeeding left and right. I felt bad for him. But he was a Packers fan, so I didn't feel that bad. And I thought to myself afterwards, you know, I had 1 win, 2 ties, and 3 losses.
Hmm.
I would rather have that and beat him than go 3 wins and 3 losses.
Really?
Yeah. Because three wins, three losses.
Yeah, I would take the 3 wins.
But I would be in the middle of the pack. Nothing interesting would have happened.
But, yeah, but, okay.
At least, yes, I'm low. I'm not doing well. And
but I got to beat the Packers.
I got to beat the Packers, yes.
I got to play Aaron Rodgers. He came over and played Blood Bowl.
I beat him. Something.
Look, yeah, I guess
I'll take my victories where I can find them, sir.
That's true. And you did.
So that was my experience. I had a ton of fun. Everybody was nice. Everybody's a lot of fun. But I am not taking humans ever again.
It's too confusing. I'm just kidding.
Taking lizardmen next year, I think.
Ooh.
It's said here now.
I said it's there. I've been saying it for a while. Yeah,
now it's done.
He talked about it before.
Yeah, I want a Lizard Man team, so this forces me to get one and paint it.
Excellent.
And it gives me a year to do so.
And you'll wait till last minute.
Which might be just enough time. Yes. So, Scott, how'd you do on yours?
Day two started off just like the last couple games of day one. Like I said, after winning the Nurgle Legacy team for the Prime family, it just was not good.
Yeah, Scott can complain about the Blood Bowl games, but
he got all the drawings, it felt like.
He won a drawing, the Nurgacy, Nurgle Legacy team, and the Scavenger Hunt. So. Yep.
What's funny is I joked about winning that Legacy team from the beginning.
Yes.
At work and everything else. I'm going to win it. Anyways.
You should have said he was going to win Chaos Cup.
I should
have done that. Yeah.
So I played a guy named Saul that you probably, if you've listened to Slurpcast, you probably heard Johnny P or Extreme. Flying Dingle is his online handle.
Yeah.
He's been known to win. He had, like, for his reroll markers, he had the little NAF trophies that you only get for winning tournaments and stuff like that.
He had three of them.
Yeah, he was, if I remember right, last year at Chaos Cup, he was always on the top row of tables and stuff, or maybe even near the finals. Anyways, good player, good solid player. I played the Chiquita Bananas. They were Amazons. He didn't have names, so I could tease him and say, come on, man, let's fluff this up. Get this Amazon team some fluff.
Fluff my banana, man.
Exactly.
There's no player names.
I know. It's sad.
Fluff it.
If I'm going to get beat, I'd rather get beat by, like, you know, Connie Dribblesnot instead of player one.
Player one. Continue.
Anyways, I played Amazons. He got plus two fame against me, so I had no fans there. So I blame it on the Ginger Badger fans.
They failed to show up.
It was actually very interesting. He was one of the Dice Cup guys. A lot of guys used the Dice Cups.
Yep.
And at first I thought that was kind of stupid. Yeah, just from an outsider playing against a guy with the Dice Cups, and he had the little sideboard to put the dice on. Mm-hmm. I actually really liked it.
Mm-hmm.
So I might become a Dice Cup guy.
I would.
I liked it too.
I'd like the leather NAF ones they had.
Right.
I like that, but I'd like to, you know how we've rolled dice and then we go, wait a second, I think you're supposed to get two dice. And then you go, wait. And you try to cover up the dice so you don't see the results. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you don't have to worry about that with a cup. You just don't lift it up, you know.
Yeah.
So it's kind of nice. Anyways.
And it's quiet.
Unless they have a metal or a plastic one. Then it gets annoying.
I like the leather ones. Yeah. They're quiet. Yeah.
You guys tease me around here because, like Brock, and sometimes even Steve mentioned it tonight when we talked Blood Bowl, about can't stop Scott's cage. Well, everybody at Chaos Cup can stop Scott's cage. So I guess once you passed the state line of Oklahoma to Missouri, everybody can stop the cage because this guy had no problems with the cage. He's obviously faced it before. He's played Amazons many, many times. He forced me in a situation where I had to make a lot of dodges to end the first half to try to go up 1-0. I failed. Yeah. Second half, we had a struggle. I stymied him. He stymied me. And eventually it came down to the last play, and the ball, he tackled me. The ball bounced into one of his guy's hands, so he had to make, I think, two blocks or dodge away. He had the reroll, so he chose to make the blocks. And he pushed his guy where all he had to do was walk into the end zone.
Mm-hmm.
And so he beat me. There was like one play left, and I was just so heartbroken. They called 2 minutes left, and I didn't want to. I knew really, theoretically, he could even stall out without being stalling because there's only 2 minutes left.
Mm-hmm.
I knew I wasn't going to be able to get two turns in, even if it was a riot or, you know, turn back the clock. So we just called it a game, and he won 1-0. So it was a heartbreaker to lose that close. I injured his guy. I cast he's one of his, like, good players, and he apothecaried it and got it right back. So, yeah.
Hmm.
Anyways, good game. I was glad that, you know, I recognized the name. I knew he was a good player and known in that area for being a good player. So I was glad to have at least a close competitive game against him. I felt like I made a few mistakes against him, too. So last game I got to play Arthur Inkpen, his fish canners, or Southland fish canners. Really, this was a game where his dice didn't do him any favors, and I kind of rolled him. I won 2-0. I had more casualties than him.
Yeah.
His team's really cool, though. I love the squids as squigs as blitzers and his troll guy. So his troll tried to eat his players and stuff like that. I mean, everything went wrong really for him, and everything went right for me. I won 2-0. So
nice.
It was so late in the game, instead of playing by a bunch of crowded people, I told Arthur, I said, let's go back to one of these tables in the back, and we just had our own table to ourselves, and we had a lot of fun, though. So
good. Cool.
Arthur's a cool guy, and he's a fun player, too. So, and he never gave up. The game was even over, and he was still trying to do stuff and, you know, for stats. So
I just remembered I was playing Dr. Kitties. I just like calling him that. But he had the...
I swear I think that guy's name is Dr. Kittles, but I'm going to look it up.
I think it's Kitties.
It might be
Kitties. I like Dr. Kitties better, even if it is. So I'm playing him, and he's got two mummies and a zombie. In the yes, I remember during yours, not mine. Sorry. But he leaves the ball carrier in the back behind his line, and I race through, and I blitz him, and I strip the ball. The ball comes out, and it bounces to his zombie that's in between two mummies, dead center in the line. And there's just nothing I could do. He just tore me up.
That's so interesting, Steve.
I know, I should have remembered it on mine. Perhaps
you should have said that on your turn to talk.
I remembered other details, too, because it was raining. And it rained on, like, three of my games. And one time it even changed weather to rain again. And it got real annoying.
Wow.
Yeah.
That'd been
interesting. When I'm not trying to remember stuff, then I can remember stuff.
I'm just giving you a hard time. I will tell this to Arthur. As much as I love you, brother, name your players, too. I didn't like playing against Goblin with two heads.
Well,
I generally played with Double Stuffed Johnny, or whatever his name is.
Wow. That's telling.
I'm just saying.
No, he had he had them named.
This roster just wasn't named?
Right.
Oh, okay.
There was a problem with the roster.
He has all his fluff and stuff online, too.
All his stuff's online, so.
I apologize, Arthur.
But he still loves you.
He still wants to play against Double Stuffed Johnny.
Double Stuffed Johnny.
Dude, if I bring my Underworld team back, he has two heads. He's going to be called Double Stuffed Johnny.
I like that. Oh, no, it's Double Stuffed Johnny.
Look out for that guy. All right, Alan.
All right, down to me.
You got two
games. It is down to you, Alan.
All right. So Steve finished 1-3-2, and even if he went 3-3, he wouldn't have been happy.
So you're saying win-loss tie. So he got one win, three
loss. That's because I'm sorry. That's how NFL does it.
I know, but I'm
back in the day.
But if we look on the NAF website, they do it.
I went 1-2-3.
Yep, you did.
Right, he had two ties, three losses. And I won two games, lost three, and tied one.
So you went 2-1-3.
2-1-3.
And we knew at the end of the first day that we were trailing three die block by about 60 points.
Right.
We did not do ourselves any favor. So
we needed a good day and them to have a bad day.
Needed Alan to have a very good day.
Yep, exactly.
And?
Well, the first game did not bode well. I played that game against the orcs that originally played against Scott at the beginning with the Mats.
Oh, the Bashers?
Yep, the Bach Bashers.
Ah, Matt from Texas.
Yep, the Wild Man from Texas.
Just a side note, Matt didn't lose any at Chaos Cup except to me. And I only bring that up is because he keeps giving me shit on Twitter. So, Matt, boom! I'm never playing Orcs again, brother, at a tournament. Boom!
And also, we made up poker chips. Yes. So that we gave out poker chips to everybody that we played. You know, we had, on mine, it was my face, and then my team logo. Scott's was his face and his team logo. And Alan's was the Both Down logo, and then his team logo.
So I'm not lucky enough to have a face.
Right. So, we handed these out to people. Mm-hmm. Well, of course, you both played Matt, mm-hmm. and Scott and I both played Arthur.
Right.
So they each got one from two out of
us.
Three.
Yes.
And then we ended up giving them each the last one to complete their collection.
Yep.
So those are the only two people in the world
that have
a complete collection of Both Down Challenge poker chips.
Correct.
Not that anybody cares. Except both those people.
Those guys care. They were actually
awesome. Yeah.
I teased Matt, but he was actually giving me just a hard time just for the fun of it, too. So.
Yeah.
Well.
All right, so you got your butt kicked by him.
Well, yeah, and it was the only time that I had a loss with 0 points. That is the absolute worst game I played. I could not roll well. He played the cage very well.
Halflings are not great at getting into the cage. I'll tell you that right now. There was a couple times where I thought it was kind of cool that I was throwing halflings into the cage to try to knock his players over.
Yeah, but the moment you're throwing halflings to break up a cage, you know you're in trouble.
Oh, I knew I was in trouble. I knew it. But, I mean, that was the fun part to me. I was like, oh, this is going to be fun. I'm just going to keep throwing the halflings at him, and hopefully I'll get one of these guys down.
Yeah.
I think I did once, but, I mean, there was no way. I couldn't beat him. So I lost that one 0-2. So walking into the last game, I was really upset. You know, that was fine. But I played against the last guy.
But going into the last game, what was your record?
At this point, still just one win and one tie at that point.
But so you're going for the Stunty Cup.
Exactly.
And we come to find out there's only three Stunty teams.
Don't say that part. Dude, it diminishes it.
I'm just saying.
Oh, my gosh.
It made me feel horrible.
No, it's good. Still.
No, it'd be worse. No, 30.
There's 45 Stunty teams.
Would you believe 4,000?
Would you believe 4? Would you believe a very pissed off nun?
A little boy with match cars.
Tennessee
match
tuxedo.
Okay, I was trying to figure out what you lamos were trying
to...
It's a little bit of a two. Yeah.
It's Don Adams.
Right.
Okay, great. Can we talk Blood Bowl?
Would you believe?
What? Okay. It's my turn. I get to do tangents.
I like Get Smart.
So the last game was against a guy, I don't know his real name. His name is Wartruck online.
It's Lamont Cranston.
No, it's not.
Could be.
Is that from the Cosby Show?
No.
No, that was the Blitzer from Saul's team. Number four.
It's the Shadow.
No, I don't know.
I have no idea.
No, I don't. Okay. Wartruck.
Wartruck, yes. He had a necromantic team. And I kid you not, his name was his team's name was Muffin Buttons. I did not understand what that meant. Yes, Muffin Buttons. I don't understand the name.
Muffin Butts?
Nope. Muffin Buttons. Okay.
Okay.
And that was his name. And he deferred.
We love fluff.
Yes.
But we like to understand it.
He deferred to me on the kickoff. He won the kickoff, you know, the flip coin toss. And he deferred to me to let me receive the ball first.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, okay, that's awesome. This was the only guy that ever, the only game that I played the whole time that I did not get to finish the game, by the way. It took a long time to get through this game.
Yeah.
But it wasn't a big deal. We weren't really too upset with it, and, you know, we weren't really trying to hurt each other. And the end of the first half, the score was, and I kid you not, 3-3.
The end of the first half.
The first half.
Jeez.
3-3. Okay, second half starts, and it's almost the end of the, you know, we don't have much time left. I think we only had, like, about 20 minutes at this point. We're playing the game, and I actually had to kick the ball off to him, was lucky enough that he wasn't able to get the ball out of his side of the field, and had two great opportunities to score on him.
Yeah.
But it just did not come into fruition. So we ended the game with the time out. I might have been able to score if I had a little bit more time, but who knows. Ended up being a tie, 3-3. So I finished up the entire day with one win, two ties, and three losses. However, I will say this.
Which is the exact same record that I have.
Not only that, but it is beating my goal of what I wanted. Yes. It said 25%. I think online it says that it was 33%.
Exactly.
Very good, Alan.
Yes.
In the grand scheme of things, Alan, I, and Arthur all had the same record.
Pretty much, yep.
And we were 67, 68, and 69.
I beat them by other stats. So I was ranked higher than them, too.
Yes.
Good job, fellas. Good job.
No, good job, Alan. No,
exactly. Come on. You guys gave me a lot of guff over taking the halflings, and I did better than you guys expected. Especially, come on, 4-0.
Well, yeah.
4-0 on one game.
That's one game.
Did you get close to 4-0?
Well, I played you Friday night, and did you close anything to me?
Now, there he goes.
I think somebody after day one was going like, I hope I don't play you.
I know. I didn't want to. And I did, sort of. Matt's team was you, and I lost 0-2. It was the only 0 game I had. Overall, my touchdowns ratio whatever it was, overall was 12-12.
Nice.
Touchdowns for, touchdowns against.
Good for you.
Thank you.
But what did that get you?
That also got me?
A trip.
What?
A trip.
Around the world?
Up. To receive a real award at Chaos Cup.
Yes.
Yes.
I actually did receive an award.
What'd you get?
The Stunty Cup. I won it.
Alan is the Stunty Cup champion Chaos Cup.
So let me tell you something. If I would have told you...
Of three people. But still.
If I would have ran over and told you during that game, like, you hold on and get a tie and you can win Stunty Cup, would that have made you nervous?
No.
Okay. Because I did the math in my head, and I knew the results from the other Stunty teams already. And I was like, I'm pretty sure if Alan ties this, he wins Stunty Cup. And I told Steve, should I tell him? He's like, no.
I was going for the win anyway. So.
Well, yeah.
Okay, well.
That's the only good thing, is he'd still go for the win.
Absolutely. Well, I'm glad I didn't tell him, because, yeah.
And the guy was really playing against, I mean, he was pretty nice enough about it. He knew I was trying to, you know, because that was the only thing I could go for. And I was like, you know, I really want to win the Stunty Cup. I know I'm pretty close. I just don't know where it
like,
is.
Like, dude, let me score. Come on.
No, I'll
give you this cool coin. It has their faces on it.
I might have kind of hinted that way with the inflection of my tone and my voice, but never actually said it. And he was like, well, I understand. You know, let's go ahead and play as much as we can. Maybe you can score. So he gave me the opportunity.
Yeah.
We could have stopped. But he never gave me the opportunity as far as leaving the ball open. Damn
no,
it.
He right. didn't. No, I saw so that. Played, no, he those was, werewolves were all over that
yes,
ball.
Yes, they were. Yes, so, they were.
So, yes, werewolves. Alan, at the end of the day, he gives out all the awards. And we did good. I mean, we got the scavenger hunt champion award.
I beat the Packers. That was my only good thing.
We know. I mean, if you could have just went 1-5, that would have been good enough for you as long as it was against the Packers team.
Yep, yeah.
It's a lot better than going 4-2.
No, that's different.
If you lost to those, that team.
If I could have won two games against two human teams that were based off the Packers and lost the other four, I would have done that over winning Chaos Cup.
No, Lord, no.
What if you could only win one game, but it was against Core, the number one NAF champion?
That would be cool.
That guy went undefeated, and he didn't make it to the finals through tiebreakers.
Yeah. Just because he had one tie at the end, I think.
I know he had a tie, but still. He...
Hold on. I want to point out one other thing. We didn't mention as well that his first game, the number one guy who played Blood Bowl, the NAF champion, played against the brand new person, wasn't it? Yeah,
yeah, round one. First tournament. Guy hasn't played Blood Bowl really ever.
Well, not tabletop. He played the computer, I think.
Oh, okay.
But it was his first tournament.
But still. Yeah. Still.
Yeah.
He broke his cherry.
It is nice.
Yeah.
I will destroy you.
But Alan got to go up and get a Stunty Cup award. Congratulations to Alan.
Thank you, sir.
Stunty Cup, Chaos Cup champion. You're going to be in all the record books now.
Yep.
Because they don't give a crap about Team Scavenger Hunt. So congrats to you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I mean, it was only against three other people, but still. It's mine.
Well, actually, two other people.
I had a disappointing showing. Steve was worse again.
Yeah.
Me and Steve dropped the ball. Oh, in the podcast challenge, we lost.
Yeah. So
we lost by, I think, 80 points, which is just one tie and one win away from.
Mm-hmm.
And really, 3-Dot Block didn't do that great either. We, as podcasts, we did pretty bad overall.
Yes. So as jovial as we make it, lost the challenge. So
we did lose the challenge.
Final episode. So, yay. Yippee.
That's what that means.
Yeah.
So
this is it?
3-Dot Block's taking over.
This is it. We got one more break and then we can come back with some shout outs and
do we want to touch on anything that we did on the way home? Because I'm pretty sure we just left really quick and drove home.
Oh god, yeah.
We said our goodbyes to everybody.
Yep. It was pretty intense. I thought it was kind of cool that, you know, the whole time we were there, it did feel a lot like being in a fraternity / camp.
Yeah, it did have a whole camp feel. It was awesome.
It was a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
If you go next year, stay at the hotel. Just
absolutely
so much fun, more fun.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of wish we did a little bit more, like we had more time to do more stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'd be nice, but there's just not much time.
Yeah, we're not rich.
Exactly.
This podcast doesn't pay all the bills.
Doesn't pay anything.
So our trip home, we got in the car, we drove forever.
Yes.
We had
stopped in Missouri again.
To have a Cracker Barrel meal.
Yeah,
which was awesome.
Which was delicious because we were just so hungry and tired. Mm-hmm. And then we stayed the night. We're in Rolla.
No, it was in something field. Not.
I don't know.
Some
Mayfield?
No. Some town.
I think it was Mayfield.
I think it was Mayfield.
And then we drove like 4.5 hours the next day and came home.
Yep.
Nothing big, actually.
And
we
then
were
we
just
crashed.
Tired.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was slept.
Yeah.
Not the car.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
I'm a good driver. Very good driver.
Definitely good driver.
Yeah. Alan drove the whole trip. Thank you, Alan.
No problem. I enjoyed it.
And I just slept when I wanted to sleep.
I didn't have a problem. No, I know. You couldn't handle staying up.
All right.
I guess we'll wrap this up and come back with shout outs and our final goodbyes.
Yeah, let's wrap this segment up and let's get this over with.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, both. don't talk down to them like that. I just want to say, this is breakfast, and, yes, I'm grotty. I just want to say, listen about down, with Steve, and don't forget, and Scott. So, coming up next, hey, it's time for shout-outs. Grotty. Grotty. Please settle down, breakfast. Oh, breakfast, you're embarrassing me again.
And we're back for, I guess, what is going to be the final segment of Both Down Under, Stephen Scott.
Yep. Next month, the three die block takeover.
It's a little depressing.
Well, hold
it's
on.
It's a lot depressing.
Let's be upright, man. And let's say that we challenged them. We lost.
They challenged us.
Or challenged us, whoever challenged whoever. It doesn't matter now. Congrats to three die block for winning better than us at Chaos Cup.
Yeah.
You guys deserved it. You beat us head-to-head or tied us.
Yep. And so,
I didn't play. Oh.
Yeah, oh, it's my fault.
Well, I was going to say it wasn't my fault because I head-to-head against the other stunty team. I beat them. So, well, I'm glad it wasn't me.
You tied.
I was going to mention if anybody wants a Chaos Cup t-shirt, they can contact us and I can get one created for them. I believe they're $20 each. And
I
then
think they were $25.
Oh, they might
could
be
wrong.
I might quote someone 20, but they're either 20 or 25. It's probably 25 then.
Contact you through what?
BothDownPodcast@gmail.com.
But
I can still log in.
That's our email, dude.
I don't know.
They can have their own email.
Don't they have like 3DieBlock at Studio Radio?
I don't think they know how to use email. Possibly.
Isn't Nod Hero controlling their email?
I think so. So they'll have Johnny allowed me to do their t-shirts so I can get more created. I'll probably put them up on our website as well.
Okay.
Just to make it easier.
Sure.
And also on the second day, as we're walking back from breakfast, all three of us, we have our second t-shirt on that just has Both Down with skulls on. Because we had two t-shirts for two separate days. And we see the 3Die Block team walking out of their hotel room. And they're all wearing different t-shirts that don't match. And who was it? Chance is like, no, I guess it was Drew, was like, what, two t-shirts? I was like, yeah, we got two t-shirts for 2 days. That's how you pimp it. Mm-hmm. Or something.
Represent.
We have to represent. It was very funny at the time.
Well, let's do shout outs and then let's say our goodbyes and let's get this over with. This podcast has been long enough.
Fine.
So you want to do your shout outs first, Steve?
Yep. Congratulations to Rich Harrop, Pinback, who won our Nuffle contest. He drew us a nice little picture of Nuffle. We'll be getting a t-shirt out to him with Nuffle on it and the copy of the 4-back trade paperback.
Right, for the Blood Bowl.
Uh-huh. We'll put multiple pictures on our website of all the different entries. I know Scott never finished his, so he'll probably get that to me, and we'll put that up as well. You can also check out Rich's blog at whatwouldnuffledo.blogspot.co.uk. I also told Andrew Nuttall that I would give him a shout-out on his Power Armored Beard Fantasy League.
Okay.
It's like fantasy football, but using
the stats from Blood Bowl, right?
Right. Players from his Blood Bowl league.
That's pretty unique.
It's awesome. I've joined up. I was leading last week, and I think I'm in a close fourth right now or something. My Belland Hogs. You can check out all the information there at Power... It's all one word. Power Armored, ARMOURED, Beard, BEARD, .com. And it has all the information. And then someone had advised us that our 5-star reviews in other countries we can't see. So anyone who's left a review for us from anywhere but the U.S. on iTunes, we want to give a shout out and say thanks for that. Also, we had 2 new 5-star reviews since we've last podcasted. True Blue 1974 and Recepa, RICEPA, both left some nice comments on iTunes. So when you get a chance, go check it out and let us know what you think.
All right.
Not that you need to let us know. I mean, we don't care. Doesn't matter
anymore.
Alan,
you got any shout-outs?
Oh, I was just going to shout-out to the guys that we saw at Chaos Cup. I mean, they were awesome, great guys. I don't think I've said that enough during that night and the whole trip.
Yeah, we came back from the dinner.
That was like a sub theme.
And Alan kept going, Those are great guys.
They're just great guys.
They're just
great guys.
And it truly is. Yeah. That's the great thing. I posted about this on the forums over at Zlurpcast. The Blood Bowl community's very lucky to have a great group of people. Mm-hmm. The whole time that I've played, the different tournaments I've gone to, I'm sure I've met over 100 people playing this game. I don't know a single douche among them. People have different play styles. They might, you know, crutch dwarves or something. Mm-hmm. They're not, you know, I might not like it, but that's the game. I don't have anything against them. And they're always great fun to play against.
Mm-hmm. Sure is a different environment than the people on Fumble that get brave sitting behind the computer talking smack or laughing or whatever else. When you're tabletoping against somebody, you're right across from them. And they can go like, Scott might not be able to catch me if I ran away, but I'm sure not going to say anything to his face, even if he is stupid. Although most of the guys don't hide behind a, you know, a computer screen.
So. Right.
Well, yeah. So I just wanted to basically shout out to all those guys that we met up there, especially the multinational people.
Conglomerate.
Yes. It was actually a lot of fun. I enjoyed it all. I mean, it were too many people for me to list out by name specifically.
Exactly. And we are from Oklahoma, so we don't really talk to many people from other countries. So it was just nice to have that different viewpoint.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That was kind of neat. And oh, I have to say this one part at least. K-Raf, I think I owe him $2 still. He said not to worry about it, but
for newspapers or
yes,
my $2.
No, nice. We were at the when we were waiting for the train to come by. We happened to sit at the same table, and they gave us one check for the full table, and all I had was a 20, and all he had was a 20. So he said, oh, you didn't worry about it. You just had one.
So, Kent, I want you to get a hold of Alan and make him pay you that $2, since right now you're probably thinking about that. So
exactly.
Yeah. Well,
it's $2, man. That's a lot of
$2.
Money.
$2.
I know. I got to eventually get that to him.
All right. I would like to, you know, you guys actually mentioned a lot of people that I'd like to already mention, but so that's already been done. But I would actually like to really thank Johnny and all his Chaos Cup committee crew.
Absolutely, yeah.
Very smooth tournament for at least from our perspective as players. Now, he might have been feeling anxiety and stuff inside before and after and during the event. But, you know, hats off to, you know, Johnny P, Johnny Paletis for doing a great job. Extreme Brian Mitchell for helping out when he can when he wasn't playing. Mike Muller, Valdrick, you know, doing the same thing. Mm-hmm. And then the wives of those guys. I mean, I don't know if my wife would sit around for 2 days and waste a whole weekend.
Oh, I know she wouldn't.
Checking in things and giving out bags and dealing with people. So, you know, hats off to Heather, Johnny's wife, and Jennifer, Extreme's wife, for putting up with us and hanging out and stuff. So,
and I do want to say, we hit 80 this year. And by we, I mean Johnny and the Chaos Cup crew. They hit 80 this year.
Mm-hmm.
And there was like 56 Dungeon last Bowl. Year, I think.
56 or 58, one of the two. Dungeon Bowl in Germany, one of the other majors, had 90.
Wow.
That's a European tournament. There's a lot more European players than there are American.
Right.
So next year,
let's go for more.
We need to hit at least 90.
Let's go if for 100. Not 100. Yeah, let's break the century mark.
I think if everybody brings an extra buddy, I think we really might.
We're trying our best to get people out and about. And, you know, just buddy up with people in your local leagues, find people in your area, anything. You know, if you can convince one more person to go and everybody else does the same, we have a huge, huge tournament.
We can rent a bus and then people can...
We could. We can rent a bus.
Yeah, we talked about that.
That's exactly what Alan wants, is renting a bus.
No, I meant, like, if we rented a bus here, the people from Texas can just, like, drive up here. And
that'd
be
awesome.
And then we can all just jump in there, and then I'll drive all the way up there.
Dude, that'd be awesome.
Road
trip.
Can I finish my shout-outs?
No.
Can I?
Oh, yeah, you can. No. I didn't know he had to ask permission.
Well, you're just going to keep talking about random party bus stuff, you know?
Well, bang bus.
Yes, that's what people want to do, is ride in a bus and get banged by you.
No, they don't want to. They still do it.
All right. Actually, we've talked to everybody. I've talked pretty much about everybody, every and anybody that I've had on my list. Again, repeating it, I just can't say enough. It really felt like a 40-man or 30-man tournament.
Mm-hmm.
It ran that smooth. And we appreciate it. Really they had plenty of water for us to drink during the rounds and everything else. So really good time. Those guys should be very proud, and anybody that went to Chaos Cup should be proud that you are a part of that. I mean, so let's keep it up, guys. Like Steve said, grow the community and stuff. So,
yeah. Mm-hmm. Even though this is our last podcast, we
end up in a freaking era.
Yeah. Well, we had a great time. Great
run. Say your goodbyes.
We had a lot of great fans, got great support. You can still keep track of us on Twitter at BothDown.
Yeah, they're not getting that.
No, they couldn't even figure it out. Not here. I would have to do it.
Yeah, he can't run two Twitter accounts.
Exactly. It's too confusing. You can also follow me at Kilowog2814.
You can follow me at FatFinley, FatFinley. And if you did follow us, you would know that we tweeted out as much as we could at Chaos Cup our rounds and results. Yeah. So,
and Alan, what's yours?
Mine
what's
your Twitter account? At Alan the OU fan.
Okay.
Spelled out straight.
And
our email address is BothDownPodcast@gmail.com. I'll still be running that. You can always check our website, BothDown.com. You can register for Nuffleween. We'll still be doing that.
That is November
3rd.
3rd.
And pre-registration is open. You get both sets of dice. People are already pre-registering to get them.
And there's only so many slots on that. So,
exactly.
Sign up early.
Our newsletter is also on that website, so we can send out more information. Should be getting a store open with different t-shirts if you guys want them. What, Alan?
No, it's just
okay.
Winding down.
It's just sad.
Yeah.
I know. In all honesty, guys, it's been a great run. I really appreciate all the both fans.
This is our album. We appreciate both of our fans.
Okay. We've been talking a lot tonight, and it's very late right now. In all seriousness, people around the world, all those people that, you know, Alan mentioned and stuff, all the people that are just fans of the show, me and Steve got into this to do a Blood Bowl podcast because we love Blood Bowl and we love the fluff and the history behind it. We're going to still keep doing our leagues. We're going to keep building on the fluff.
And Scott's going to learn not to take challenges when we can't back him up.
Well, Scott expected to do better for himself. But, you know, they earned it. And I just want to thank all the fans. It's been a great year. No matter what happened, so this is the end. It doesn't matter. We've grown the community because there's many people that told us that now I do this for my league. Now I think of player names. I do this and that. So no matter what, we have accomplished what we wanted to do. And we've had more success than what we thought. I mean, we've reached a ton of people. I just want to thank you guys so much for, you know, as stupid as it is, we don't get paid for this. We don't get anything for it except just to do it for fun. And it's really awesome that you guys appreciate the work we put into this. And I hope that, I assume it's going to be Chance and Drew that take over, but I'm not sure on that.
Oh, yeah. Well, extra guys. They're going to have to come down to the studio and take it over.
So we leave the keys to pick up the keys from Steve and take over and enjoy.
Wait,
do you have one more thing, Alan?
Wait, hold on. They're coming down here to do the.
Yeah.
Come into your studio.
Yeah, they got to come to the studio and take it over.
They're taking over the podcast, yes.
That's them and producer Craig.
If I bought Walt Disney World, they wouldn't bring Walt Disney World to me.
Yeah, right.
I would go down to that there.
Yeah, so they got to come here and take it over.
But then who's at their studio running their podcast while they're down here?
What do you mean?
I mean...
You mean Three Die Block Studio?
Yeah. So...
Well, I guess producer Craig's going to come with them to work the computers.
Mm-hmm.
What are you saying,
mm-hmm.
Alan?
Mm-hmm.
I know what Alan's saying.
Yep.
Road trip!
Both Down is a production of Couch Pirate Radio. Please drop by couchpirates.com to hear more of their podcasts.
Steve's giving us the move on signal. Oh, he's mad. We broke the fourth wall.
I'll just cut it. But yes, we at 40 minutes.
Okay.
So.
Oh, sorry.
You can't tell me to give you a heads up on time and then get mad if I give you a heads up on time.
Sorry.
I will rape you.
I know this is your podcast.
God.
It's my podcast. I got the equipment.
It's the only thing I bring to it.
So hurry up.
Jesus.
Hurry up and get over with it. Let's get done.